our Twitch up. I'm mad. Baby, say something inspirational.
Never give up when there's sunshine at the end of every rain.
That is the gayest thing you've said for a while. I'm joking. I'm joking, love. I'm just...
I tried so hard.
I got so far.
In the end, it didn't really fucking matter. I had to... Well...
I'm very upset right now. Baby, I'm so upset. And now I gotta do my plugs now. But we're streaming right now, just to let you know, love.
We are?
Yeah. Because, okay. Well, I'm streaming on Twitch because I couldn't do YouTube. Because YouTube was like, oh no, you exceeded your thing. Bullshit. I streamed twice. On Thursday and I think Wednesday. Did I stream Wednesday, baby? Baby, go check.
Hold on.
Go check if I did.
I can't hold on.
Fine.
Please.
Fine.
Please.
I love you.
Potato beans.
Potatoes. Yay. God, sound so adamant about it.
What?
Love you too.
I said all you need to. Is this Shin in Strum Final Fantasy World, that one?
Well, there was another one before that. That was the
Shin Spoopy Game Stream?
No, there was one after that one. It was Dragon Ball Z. Xenoblade.
Oh.
Yes.
The Strum was 2 days ago.
Yeah, exactly. See? I don't understand. I don't understand Twitch. I mean YouTube. Why? Why do you hate me, baby? Why does YouTube hate me?
Because what is love?
Baby, don't hurt me.
Don't hurt me. No more.
No, hurt me more. Hurt me more.
You masochist.
How would you know?
Because you just said hurt me more.
Yeah.
You're just like, baby, one more time.
Smack me one more time.
I don't remember the rest of the lyrics.
It's killing me. Still believe. Spank my asshole one more time.
Oh, we went totally different ways.
You know I...
You said spank, I said whip.
You know I would, though.
We totally went two different ways with that.
Yes.
What game are you playing?
DanganRonpa.
Oh, DanganRonpa?
Yeah. DanganRonpa. Yeah, you would say that, huh?
Can we just be Bach?
I wish. What?
I'm hyper.
Are you like hyper, Shiro?
I don't know.
Nah. Okay. So, I got the plug on the Shin Nagawa Facebook. And now I gotta make a little quick video. Like a five second. Like a minute or something. I don't know. I'm fucking pissed.
Don't get my get grabbed.
Why, baby? Why does Twitter? Why does YouTube do this? Oh, and also I'm recording. So, hey guys, this is a quick notification that I am going over to Twitch right now because YouTube will not let me stream on there. Hooray! Even though 2 days ago I actually streamed Final Fantasy World, but guess what? YouTube's like, no, I don't care. YouTube, fight me. Ya fuck. So we're gonna at least be doing trigger happy havoc DanganRonpa over there. So come check it out. Come, and we'll be streaming until like, I don't know, 1 or 2, maybe 3. Let's see how far of insanity we get to in this chapter. So for now, see you there. Bye. Baby, you're a banana.
I'm a banana. Look at me, go.
I don't think they said motherfucker.
Banana power,
banana power, banana power. Look at me move.
Uh-oh, banana time. Oh my god, that's so old.
Baby, I think we were thinking of two different banana videos. Because I don't remember him saying banana time.
Yeah, no, it was part of like this little animation as well. That had that song with it.
Oh, then, I don't know. Then. I guess I was remembering the actual live action one where it was like, I'm a banana. Look at my mouth! Banana power. And
my turtle, he's like moving marbles around because I'm guessing he's finding extra food at the bottom. And after I just said that, he stopped and he like looked at me.
It's like, you better give me food.
I'll give you a treat right now.
Oh, I get a treat?
No, not you.
Fuck. I didn't agree to this situation then, son of a bitch. Man, I'm hungry. I need to eat my sandwich. Alright, is that it? Hey guys, it's Shin Nagawa. Bad news at the stream. Oh, okay, yeah. All right, can I have this quickly upload? So quickly upload. Beautiful. That is, you know, what's the title of that video? That super short video letting everyone know I'm streaming on Twitch?
What?
Streaming on Twitch because YouTube hates me! Flush! I'm literally plugging. I'm pressing just Control V for my paste. And it just says twitch.tv/shinnagawa, twitch.tv/shinnagawa, twitch.tv/shinnagawa. You're proud of me.
I'm so proud.
I hate.
I'm so happy. I'm so proud.
Don't patronize me. What?
I said I think I have some issues.
Baby, we both have issues, but we accept it. I think. Did you accept eating me yet, you had baby?
What?
I said,
did
you accept
what?
Did you accept me yet, baby?
Of your issues?
I meant just like in general. But oh, yeah. Okay, sure. Wow.
So wait, are you asking if I accepted your demons?
Wait, what?
Is that what you're asking, if I accepted your demons?
You're so stupid.
Because you just said, did you accept me? I'm like, as your gayness?
You're so stupid.
How am I stupid? You just said, do I accept you?
I meant like,
He's whatever. I give up. Anyways, we're gonna start doing DanganRonpa. Cause is
you mean DanganRonpa?
I'ma fight you. I'ma fight you.
Why?
Cause I can. You brat.
Cause you wish you were cool like me.
You're funny. Shit.
That's what I hate.
What?
That's what I hate.
I'm gonna fight you.
It's okay, and I need to use it.
Baby, you're so dumb. Fight me. Fight me. Fight! What is wrong with you?
No. I don't know.
Whatever, we're starting.
Okay.
I mean, well, we already started. It's just we just kept talking.
Well, what do I do?
Well, let me get the let me first eat my sandwich, and then I'll explain the simple process.
You're gonna eat your sandwich?
Yes. My steak and cheese sandwich from Subway. Subway, sponsor me!
Is that Subway?
Mm-hmm. It's good. I'm eating fresh. Baby, will I become the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air?
No.
The fuck? This is bullshit. I agreed to be the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Okay, so... very, very simple. So, are you able to see the screen?
Hold on.
Okay. What should I hold on? My dick? Oh!
Yeah, I can see it.
That got glitchy looking. Okay. Hey, give me one sec. It's gonna look weird.
Okay.
I'm gonna make sure the audio delay isn't up. Okay, it's not up. Alright, so you simply just go back and forth. You get a character.
Ikusaba.
You get a character to voice, I get a character of voice. And since you are doing this for the first time, I'll have to explain the character in a way so you can understand it, and try to either go with just your normal voice and you just read it like a child.
Okay.
Or you just, make up a voice that seems to fit the character.
I wish Sakura was here though.
I miss her. She committed suicide for all of them.
She would break you.
She would. But you know what? It would be worth it.
Okay.
Baby, I'm kidding.
Okay.
Baby.
Hey, look, I can see me.
What are you talking about?
I could see my Skype thing.
Good. Because
I could see my Yandere Skype 7.
Yandere Skype 7?
I mean, Yandere 7 of my baby. Skype profile.
I must spread all of it.
So, what? Since it's since it's trigger happy havoc, are we gonna have a lot of trigger warnings involved?
Baby, for most of it, there was a lot of triggering situations. From murdering
for you, yeah.
I was pretty triggered, though.
It makes me laugh sometimes, depending on how the person dies.
Oh, fuck you! I'm upset.
I'm a bit...
Oh, also, hail beans!
I'm a bit psycho.
Baby, I'm gonna fight you. Oh.
I'm a bit psycho. You should know this already. I don't know why you're so surprised.
I'm not. I'm just saying I'm gonna fight you.
Go for it. I already killed all your waifus.
Don't say that! Don't say that! I love you. You're so stupid. I love you.
Love you too.
Anyways, so. Hey, old beans.
I also have a future diary,
So
you know it's legit.
Wait.
You know it's legit.
So you have a flip phone? Ew.
No, it's on my phone. You know, I see those animes with the flip phones and they make it look cool.
Yeah, but then you realize in reality they kind of ass. I'm afraid I can't stay tonight at a quiz. I'm also celebrating my 17th birthday. It was yesterday, but I get more kick today too. Oh shit! Happy birthday, L Beans. You do you, man. I'm just, I don't know. Thanks for popping in, but yeah. Hope you have a you enjoy your night. Seriously, dude. Happy birthday. I didn't know yesterday was your birthday, dude.
Wait, whose birthday?
El Beans.
Oh, happy birthday to you.
You live in a zoo.
A zoo.
You look like a monkey.
And
you smell like one, too.
Beautiful.
Yes. Anyways, but seriously though, happy birthday, dude. Well, even if it was yesterday or not. Enjoy that extra birthday cake.
Enjoy your birthday.
I can't wait.
We'll eat a cupcake in your honor.
I can't wait for my birthday. No. I can wait for my birthday.
I will eat a cupcake in Albion's honor.
What about my birthday?
I will eat a whole cake in your honor.
Why?
Mukuro Ikusaba.
Oh. Also, since I'll explain certain characters for you. Ow. I hit my leg. I'll at least have to tell you whenever they have a voice with them, or whenever they don't have a voice with them. So you'll. Yeah. I see Dream Burb online, but she's not joining in. Go bother
she's
her.
She's probably busy.
Yeah, that's why she hasn't popped in at all. That's why
If she wasn't busy, she would message.
Yeah.
The 16th student, lying hidden somewhere in this school.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. The 16th student. So, in the last... Alright, so... I know that we've been randomly talking and this is all gonna be uploaded on YouTube.
Oh shit.
Yeah. We've been dicking around for 5-10 minutes tops or more.
Oh, not bad.
But in the last episode, we learned that there was apparently a 16th student. And they were named Mukuro Wasabi. And we've learned also that why Sakura died. She committed suicide to cover that murder.
She
was truly the Black End. And and Steve said hi in the group chat.
Poopy butt.
He is a poopy butt, but anyways. Yeah, but anyways. Yeah, so currently right now, thanks to Kyoko, our Miss Ultimate Investigator.
Yo, Dude, I love Kyoko.
She's pretty badass, but Sakura was awesome. Yeah, she is. You gotta admit, Sakura was pretty cool. She could punch through a wall.
She was buff. She scared the shit out of me.
Man, she made me attracted to her because that she was such a badass character.
I'm sorry I'm not muscly like she is.
Baby, I love the way you are, but she's also an inspiration for that kind of anime pride. She's that anime kind of warrior type. Amazonian boobs. She had boobs. It was hard to notice under her fucking pecs, but she had boobs.
I mean, I've seen bodybuilder women where, like, they have pecs and then their boobs are just there.
No, they're like little lemons.
Yeah.
It's so weird. Why are we talking about this? Anyways, let me get...
The one they call the ultimate despair.
They call it the ultimate despair. Baby, is this you?
Yes, I'm the 16th student. I'm the ultimate despair.
Oh, I thought you were the ultimate of despair. Get it? Get it?
Watch out for her.
Love me! Shut up, love me!
I laughed at your joke!
Love me!
Joke.
Okay, whatever. But anyways, Kyoko told me to watch out for her. Mukuro Ikusaba. I mean Ikusaba. That was 3 days before the next incident. 3 days before we would be faced with another murder. 3 days before the worst thing so far would reveal itself. Chapter 5, 100 Mile Dash, Pain of a Junk Food Junkie, Daily Life.
Sounds like my life.
Yeah. Except for you're not trapped in a school, forced to murder people.
Yeah. That'd be fun, though.
But what if I was there? You'd have to kill me. The fuck, baby?
Flip a coin.
The fuck, like baby?
If it's between me and you, and we're the only two students left, I'll flip a coin whether to kill myself or to kill you.
Well, no, if, like, long as you didn't kill anyone else, you'd be murdered if they proved that you were the killer of those other people. If they killed each other off and you did nothing until, like, the end and then you had to kill someone?
Yeah.
So... If the two of us survived and we caught whoever killed, like, a previous student that was living, then, yes. If you had the choice to, like, try...
I'd have to flip a coin.
Baby! What the fuck?
I mean, I have to go home to a family.
What the fuck? That's so fucked up.
I will do it in the most, like, honorable way. Like a samurai way.
That's still fucked up. You're planning on killing me.
Hey, if it makes you feel better, I'm gonna do a 50-50 by flipping a coin.
No. No, it doesn't.
There's a 50-50 chance that I kill myself or I kill you. You know. He's not gonna let any of us go until, like, there's only one person standing.
But here's the thing. That's what we think is going on. There might be another way out of it.
If there's another way out, then I will spare you.
Yeah. Still upset that you're still willing to murder me.
Hey, what would you do if it was between me and you?
Nothing. I'd rather spend the rest of my life with a bunch of food with you, since we might fight, but we could still enjoy it together.
Yes, but, like, what if it comes to the time where he loses his patience and starts trying to say... Alright, you guys gotta kill yourself or else I'm gonna murder one of you.
Then we should do the cliche of Romeo and Juliet. Let us die together. I don't give a fuck what he would do. But long as we can convince him to do it, then yeah, fucking I would. I'm sorry, but I'd rather not try to kill you.
Well, I'm not gonna kill you right away. Like,
you still admit killing me, though. The point being is you still admit that you would kill me if you were given no choice.
I mean, if I had, like, a purpose, like...
Oh, my God.
Like, if my mom was, like, waiting for me, then, you know, I'd have to choose my mother over you.
That's fucked up.
She's my mom!
I'm upset. I'm so upset right now. I'm upset. Yeah, but what do you think I would be missing out, baby? The YouTubes, my friends, you?
I will let you haunt me. Anyways. We got off track.
Anyways.
I said I love you, bitch!
I didn't hear you! You're so quiet sometimes! I'm sorry! I'm sorry, please fix me. I mean, what?
We got distracted.
No shit. Anyways. In the meantime, the day after Sakura's class trial, that morning in the dining hall... So let's begin the usual post-trial investigation. Hey, you didn't make small talk or anything. We never get straight to the point like that. If you don't want to keep up with me, you must refrain from pointless small talk.
There you go. So, Ali's a bubblehead, but she's super sportsy, got big boobies.
And she's pretty, like, you know, bright person. She's willing to at least stay... happy, other than the whole fear of having people die.
Donuts?
What?
Donuts?
And donuts, oh yeah.
She's my favorite character, that's why.
I'm proud of
Jeez,
you.
Jeez, how high is that horse of yours? I can't read it now.
Well?
He just acts like that to hide his own insecurities. I mean, that's true. That's what I like to think anyway. Regardless, if you want to defeat the mastermind, you need to follow my lead. They creep around the school like a mouse, but the mastermind's pride is as bloated as a cow's udder. Jesus Christ, that's a worse comparison.
In the name of my family.
And no matter what it takes, I will rid this world of them.
Ah, oh, Toka.
Hey, Toko.
<I'm red>
Got it. God damn it.
Okay, anyways.
Anyways, give me a sec. Anyways. Hey, Toko, you've been pretty quiet. Man, you're so boring now, just sitting there like a mushroom. Gonna start calling you Miss Mushroom.
What's your deal?
She didn't snap back at you.
Her talking makes things difficult, so I told her not to open her mouth without permission. Jesus Christ, she is... This is master and slave.
What? But she can't... she can't open her mouth? She can't eat! Her drink water! Oh my God, really? Really? She thinks that's what's gonna happen? Really?
Baby.
She is an airhead.
Yeah.
She's such an airhead.
And yet she was the one to survive versus the martial artist, the fanfic writer, the ultimate pop star, the ultimate baseball player.
Well, about that.
Was also in her head.
I'm not gonna lie, I thought Yasuhiro would die by now. But, why did Taka have to die? I'm so sad about that. I'm still sad about that. Anyways. And you're okay with that, Toko? That's... Jeez. How low is that rock you're hiding under?
Miss Badass herself.
I believe this is a small talk Yakia warned us against.
Come
That's
on.
The name right, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh my God, I stumbled on my words now.
Yeah, no, like, the way I remembered it is because there's another character I knew from an anime called Katekyo Hitman Reborn. And his name was Kuchiki Byakuya. And he was a bad guy, and he made my life miserable in video games.
Anyways, that's another story for another time.
Ooh, that's another stream for another time. Anyways. And yet, I let myself get involved. But it is finished. But it is now finished. I will never allow you to drag me down to your level again.
Let's go.
We're going to begin our search. Stop running your mouth and start moving your legs. Pressured by an obvious irritated Byakuya, we all started our exploration.
Jesus, what
are you sick?
He's such a bitch.
Alright, now we have free reign, so.
Oh, man.
What?
I just said, what the fuck, man?
What the fuck, bruh?
Alright, so most of the things that have been unlocked have been to the school, so for now let's investigate where the school, like, what's going on in the school. So
what? It's purple. It's green.
Yes. Thank you for stating the obvious, love. You get the cookie. Okay.
Yay!
I lie, you never get that cookie.
Can I have a donut though?
You can have a hot dog.
Oh, I'm craving a donut.
Why do you want a donut so bad?
Because, like, I was talking about how she likes donuts, and I'm just like, oh.
Next time I visit you, I'm gonna buy you something. Like, we can go to the store, and I'll buy you donuts.
You have a Krispy Kreme store?
I know, baby.
Can we go get donuts?
Yeah, we could, if we would be able. Whenever I visit you again, I'm trying to figure out when. Oh! Wait, I think the fourth floor was already open. Yeah, it was. So this is where we're at. Wait. Is this door finally unlocked? Wait, not that one. Is this door finally unlocked? Rattle. The door won't budge. It must be locked. Damn, I thought it was gonna be unlocked. My hopes were so high, but because if it would have been true. Alright, the fifth floor has been unlocked. So I'm at the fifth floor of Hope's Peak Academy. The fifth floor has been opened up to us. And it's totally different from all the floors we've seen up till now. For some reason, it feels unpleasant. Baby, it always feels pleasant. Oh yeah, look!
Oh, he likes that.
Nighttime secrets. More, no. Stomp, stomp. He's so dirty.
Jesus. What am I walking into? Maybe this is your fault.
Yes, please.
Yes, spank me, my.
What the fuck? Why is Monokuma making stuff about, Makoto?
Haha, catch me if you can. Wait up, I'm going to punish you.
Response, gross. So no one's gonna know what. Makoto's not gonna make response about that. Oh, it's Toko. Huh? Does she want to talk to me about something? Toko, what's wrong?
Dies.
Wow, she can't actually say it. Well, she can't still say anything because Byakuya said she couldn't talk. Is she trying to say something? I think she's almost just a little more and I might get it. She's angry now. I'm sorry, but I have no idea what it is you're trying to tell me. And she's frustrated.
What if she, like, cut off his tongue? Wouldn't that be, like, dark?
Wait, what?
What if he, like, cut off his tongue? Wouldn't that have been dark?
I mean, it would be a terrible idea because she has that split personality genocide Jack that could fuck his day up.
That is true.
Yeah, literally, even if, she, like, Toko would be willing, there's always that split personality that's gonna prevent her from doing it, like, going that far. Since Toko doesn't have 100% control of Genocide Jack, he has legitimately commit a lot of murders.
Alright, so Toko still can't talk because Byakuya said for her to shut up.
Byakuya, leave. Just leave.
He just left her alone, though. Wait, oh, there's Aoi right there. Boobs McGee.
Oh boy.
Oh boy! Oh, oh. Time to slide. Oh, no. Wow, this is really pretty. A suit of armor is on display. It's extremely Japanese. Nice! The target seems pretty far away. Gotta say, pretty proud of my eyesight. Nice! Damn it, Makoto, why are you so proud about that? That's not even to be proud of. Even though this room is totally enclosed, there's a cherry blossom tree planted here. And it's in full bloom.
Hey.
Oh, is that me?
Mm-hmm. Hey, yo, baby.
Quite elegant.
Is this what you consider elegant?
Indeed.
I lived overseas for a long time, so this kind of Japanese style thing is so refreshing.
But considering our situation, isn't it kind of out of place? I mean, it is.
It's refreshing.
Baby, fight me.
Sorry.
I'm kidding. Anyways, it's a straw post used for sword practice. Did they use it for training here too? Nice! Oh, that's cool. Wait, does that mean there's weapons in here then? There's a bunch of wooden lockers in here. The wooden lockers and keys remind me of super old school public bathrooms. That is the weirdest thing you could say. Alright, well, that should be it for looking around for the other stuff. Let's just talk to Kyoko now. Kyoko. Oh, what Kyoko told me yesterday. What the heck did it mean?
Yukuro Ikusaba.
Oh, she, voices.
The 16th student, lying hidden somewhere in this school. The one they call the ultimate despair.
The ultimate one that has despair.
Watch out for her.
Kyoko?
I'm not going to say anything.
What? Don't be a bitch! Huh?
I can't say anything.
You're so edgy. Kyoko what? Narrowed her eyes. Her gaze darted up to the surveillance camera.
Hey.
Mirror.
You understand why, right? I'm sure I've been weird, sorry.
Oh. Give me one sec. Okay. She was trying to tell me whatever it was important. The mastermind couldn't find out. But how did Kyoko get her hands on information that could have been that important?
So then.
We're finished here. Because she's a badass, that's why.
She made it very clear that our conversation had come to an end. And just like usual, I didn't understand anything any better than before. Good conversation, Kyoko. Good conversation. You stupid bitch.
Hey.
She's a stupid bitch.
Wait me.
Anywhere.
This floor feels different compared to all the others. I'm not sure what it is. Is there some reason for that? I hope it's not anything too creepy. Oops. I can't read either.
That's okay. I'm eating. How dare I eat whenever I'm streaming? Because I'm fucking hungry and I didn't eat anything. I only ate like one thing. Whoa!
Jesus.
What the hell is this? The grotesque horror of the room struck me hard and fast, and that's what she said.
What I saw was bad enough, but when I smelled, it was sour, pungent, and possibly rank.
I see.
It smells awful, doesn't it?
Well, that looks fun. Air shining in darkness. What's up?
It's... It must have been, like, at least vaguely familiar to you. After all, you've been around, like, you've been around your fair share of corpses. Are you saying it's the smell of blood, their flesh, and fat and blood? And that was no surprise in his voice, no shock. But he was right, I had experienced the smell.
Oh, good job, man. How was that game? I actually kind of wanted to play it, but anyways.
I had this smell more than once before. It was the smell of death and despair.
Hmm. Oh, I thought you meant despair.
Death and despair. Sorry.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the...
Anyways.
But I like how we both thought the same thing.
Yeah. It is fantastic. Oh, that's cool. Okay, I'm gonna save the last bit of my sandwich for whenever I'm done streaming. Sandwich, you will be in my belly soon.
But the smell here is strong, condensed. It's the smell of a battlefield.
Really? It was just 5 hours? Huh.
Okay. Monokuma must have...
Ooh, my favorite kick!
Come on.
What?
Now.
My fault again? Stop trying to blame me every... blame everything on me!
Blame me everything, genius.
Shut up. Leave me alone. You know I are bad with words.
Stop trying to blame everything on me!
There. Subtle playtime, but... It gets way harder with two or more people. Oh, that's cool. Anyways.
If you hadn't done what you did, this would never have happened.
Unbelievable.
No. It's quite the opposite.
The opposite?
Now then. Yep. Let me give you a itty-bitty, eensy-squeensy little hint. As far as this room goes, I don't know a thing. I just left it exactly how I found it.
What?
Yes, indeed! How's that for a hint? Better than those stupid hints you get from NPCs in those mean old RPGs. But it's pretty scary, huh? Blood all over the walls and junk. Of course, even in the outside world, people die bloody, gruesome deaths every day.
I can't wait!
It's not really a big deal to keep your chin up and keep on living, soldier.
What's he talking about?
I mean, that's a way of thinking about it.
He just left it the way he found it? What's the meaning of all this? Seriously, this entire thing is like a battlefield.
Like Battlefield 1.
Like chalk people.
Chalk people. Hmm. Spoopy. Oh no, there's spoopy chalk people ghosts. Oh no. Baby run!
Anyways, it appears all the blood stains are dry. And their color has changed. As well, I think it's safe to assume these stains are considerably old. Is that all really blood? Of course. I didn't find it interesting otherwise. And it is interesting, I assure you. What on earth happened in this
Shut up.
What on earth happened in this classroom? He seems like he's enjoying himself. No way I can keep up with someone like that.
He's just like, oh, yeah, blood. And he's just like, jerking in the corner.
I don't think I've seen everything, everything there, so... I mean, everything there is to see.
Damn. Okay, so we can't leave until we investigate around.
There are white chalk outlines drawn all over the floor. How many bodies were there?
I've seen this kind of thing on detective shows and stuff like that. You always see it at the scene of a murder. I wish I could say I didn't. I wish I could say I don't believe it.
There's writing on the wall.
Yeah, I see it.
But... eye for an eye.
A tooth for a tooth. Alright, well, I guess.
Dick for dick.
Byakuya, what about that Monokuma? I mean, about what Monokuma just told us? It's not like I'm even here. He must be lost in thought. Is he really thinking that hard, or is he just flat out ignoring me?
Yeah, he's just ignoring me.
Sounds about right. No matter where, like, no matter when, no matter where, surveillance cameras are following our every move. I mean, they're absolutely everywhere. How many cameras does this place have, anyway? Nice! Well, I guess we're done here for the most part. Leave this area. Wait, I want to check one more thing. This is one of the monitors Monokuma appears on. It seems pretty useless when it's not on. Actually, no, it's totally useless no matter what. Okay. Well, this was a riveting piece of information.
Riveting piece of news.
The only thing I can conclude... You're so dumb, baby. You're so dumb. But okay. But the only thing I can conclude about that general area is that is the area of what happened so many years ago that made this school close down.
Oh my god, this is roar!
Rattle rattle. Yes, are we going to WWE?
Yes.
No, stop. It's locked. We came all this way just to be denied here. The sign in the hall says biolab. A biolab that we're forbidden from seeing into? It kind of sounds like something out of an old cheesy horror movie.
Yes, it is.
Ah, old cheesy movie, remember? Fight me. Alright, so we already talked to Aoi. And this door is wide open. God damn it.
Sorry.
I'm proud of you. Oh my god, Pokemon! Okay, so there's a wood cabin. There's a surveillance camera. There's a Yasuhiro. Is this a chicken coop? What's a chicken coop doing here? Chickens! This place even has chickens, huh? They're just regular chickens, right?
Now we can all do the chicken dance.
No, goddamn. Like they don't eat people or lay bombs instead of eggs or something crazy like that? Buck. It seems safe. Chicken! It's a chicken. It had a sound clip of the chicken going cock-a-doodle-doo. It's really alive, right? There's no mistake. Oh my god, we can just stare at chickens. It's a chicken. It's a chicken! It's a chicken! It's a chicken! There's no point really to stare at these chickens. Not gonna lay a bomb, is it? Why did- Oh, you like- See, god damn it. Oh, you like chickens too, Makoto? Yeah, I love these little guys. They're seriously cute, right? And there's exactly 5 of them there. Exactly? 5, you know, the number that comes after 4 and before 6. At least in the terms of natural numbers. Anyway, whenever the number 5 pops up, that's a good omen. It contains the mysteries of the cosmos. Jesus Christ, Yasuhiro, stop.
I'm at least 30% right.
It's a number of power. A refreshing number on on par. With hand squeezed all natural lemonade.
Sounds like he's like trying to like sponsor something.
Yeah.
sponsored by, let me stare at my drinks. Sponsored by Sprite. Sponsor me, Sprite, so I can have more free drinks. Anyways, he never lets me get a word in on, like, word in edgewise. Jesus.
So, baby, you want to play with this giant Venus flytrap?
Yeah.
No, stop. I forbid you.
Did you say penis or Venus?
Venus fly.
Of course you'd agree to the penis one. God damn it, baby.
There's some kind of. You look like some kind of weirdo.
You want me to be honest or just be nice?
No.
Okay. Good decision. Anyways, there's some kind of control panel set near the wine. Does it control the air conditioning or something?
It's for the sprinklers!
Sprinklers?
Yeah, it controls the sprinklers in the garden! The sprinklers are set off every morning at 7:30. Don't you dare change it without permission! Of course, the setting panel is locked, so you can't change it if you want to. So that means the sprinklers go off at 7:30 a.m. every.
I mean, wait. So that goes off in every 30. Okay, you get what I mean.
Yep, you got it. It's super user friendly, which sucks. So if you get here too early, you'll get drenched. So watch yourself. But you're not a little kid, right? You're too old to go running through sprinklers anyway.
Yes. You perv.
Or do you have some kind of water fetish? I'm not gonna tell. I mean, I'm gonna tell everyone.
Oh, you kind of made me happy.
Hentai.
I'm not a hentai. You're a hentai.
Hentai.
What? What is this? This thing is super weird, super creepy. Flowers. Who's supposed to be this big? Is this thing real? Stop it.
Watch out!
What?
That's a Monokuma flower. I came up with the name myself. Try and touch it, and you're in for some real excitement. Your heart's all like, whoa! And the plant's like, snap! And your flesh is like, brrr, I'm dead.
In other words, it's a monstrosity?
It's a pretty freaking amazing. I mean, it's pretty freaking amazing, if I do say so myself. A student at Hope's Peak added improvement after improvement and created this miracle creature. The ultimate,
Botagnus. Close enough.
Although they don't go there anymore, they died during the tragedy.
Actually,
by the way, despite how it looks, the flower is super practical. It can eat paper, plastic, even people. So it's totally good for the environment. Such an eco-friendly creation is vital for the future growth of a healthy society. Not that I would know anything about that myself.
Shut up.
Sprouting more and more nonsense, Monokuma eventually disappeared. Whatever it is, I'd better keep my distance.
Nice!
Oh, okay, so that was a side conversation. It is a Venus flytrap, but a mutated Venus flytrap. Those nozzles poking out. Are those the sprinklers?
Nice!
Those are some really nice sprinklers.
Shush. Shush you.
Don't you just love the way they look? It's so...
Fight me.
Classy.
Fight me. Anyways. Just to be sure, I should take a look at the tool shed.
Oh no, we're gonna get molested in the tool shed.
Cute.
This place seems totally disorganized, from a lawnmower to fertilizer, flower pot to farm tools. Leaning against the wall, is that a pickaxe? There's different kinds of garden tools here. Are they trying to get us to become self-sufficient?
Yeah, but they said the previous person that created that Venus flytrap died from the tragedy. So that means it connects to that classroom. Yeah. Huh? I'm proud of you, baby. What did you ever do to your Monokuma plushie?
Oh, it's somewhere in my room.
Yeah, I thought so. Because I remembered because of the picture you showed me with you cuddling.
Yeah, I still have it. Oh. I wish I actually had a plushie, like a full plushie, not just a head.
You only have a head plushie?
Yeah, and you could store coins in it. But you know what? I want a jacket of Monokuma.
I'm thinking of a biker jacket with that, like, silly long hair he gets whenever he kills Mondo. You end up buying a leather jacket with the picture of a Monokuma like that, looking like, trying to look like a badass. There's some carved into the handle of this pickaxe. Crazy diamond? I feel like I remember seeing that somewhere. Wait. Crazy diamond. I won't think of I'm overthinking about it. Anyways, there's a lawnmower here. Even this here? Who's exactly gonna take care of the lawn? Nice! Hey look, baby, your favorite pot. I'm fine. Are you fine? So many flower pots, big ones, little ones, any size you might need. See, baby, you can get your pot here. Cute. You love me.
Cute.
Let me adjust your audio. I think you're a little bit low because I.
You guys
are
beating me.
What?
What?
I heard you just say, because you beat me, and I'm like, what?
I said, because you hate me?
No! I love you! Anyways, I'll grow some flowers to put in my room. But Jesus, baby! I thought I heard you say, because you beat me, and I'm like, I don't abuse people. Bags of, literally, people abuse me way more than I would abuse them. Seriously. Bags of fertilizer. What? Anyways, moving on.
I don't feel like I want to be part of the strum anymore.
Baby, no. I miss you.
You just know, said I abuse you.
I mean, I never said yes and or no.
You went, and then you changed the subject.
But that doesn't mean yes or no.
It totally means fight yes. Me. Everyone knows that means yes, and you avoid the question.
I love you. Coming from the one that's like, yeah, I would kill you so I can, like, go home. And I'm like, okay, wow. Ow. Fight me. I love you, come on. Bags of fertilizer are piled up. There's so many different kinds of kinds to choose from. You know you like it, Shin. Stop. Stop.
Who said that?
Shining Darkness. He's a friend. Like, IRL. He watches.
He knows why. Does he know that your dirty little secret?
What?
Does he know your dirty little secret?
I'll keep you my dirty little secret. No. I mean, what? No, we're not talking about this. We're moving on, baby. We're moving on from this. Anyways, oh. At first I thought I saw blue skies, but turns out they just painted the walls and the ceiling.
You know?
But the plants are all real. It seems like since I smelled vegetation, it helps me relax.
What the heck?
But that's not what you're thinking, is it? He says, I know nothing. Good. That's a good response, because you don't need to worry about that. Why is it that bad? You don't get it. Don't you realize the true horror of plant life?
Not in Hanson.
Wait, what?
What?
What'd you say?
Nothing. Continue.
God damn it, baby. Now I have to really listen to this in the stream. Whenever we're done, you brat.
And then you're gonna message me. God damn it, really?
Anyways, it's there, just beneath the surface, beneath their calm exterior. They're all, like, they're always watching and waiting. And they decide they can't leave us in charge of Earth anymore.
The end is nigh!
He's talking about Mother Nature and global warming and whatever.
They'll put their plan of global human extinction into action.
Well?
I'm serious!
Does this prove that Yasuhiro's stupid, baby?
Yes.
I mean, he's already proven enough. He's the chosen one to be the biggest idiot. I bet you if we walk away, he would literally get eaten by this Venus flytrap. So many plants. Alright, that should be it. Alright, I guess I've seen what there is to see here for now. But once again, nothing I found seems to make any real sense.
Nothing ever makes sense.
Yeah. That's life, though. Anyways, I need to head back to the dining hall and find out what the others turned off. Bam, bam. I'm not gonna lie, DanganRonpa music's so fucking amazing. One after another, everyone made their way to the dining hall. And before too long, it would appear everyone has returned. But still, it's just six of us. That's barely enough for a decent volleyball team. Why are you...
That's actually enough for a decent volleyball team.
For
hey,
what?
Don't be a sourpuss. We gotta think positive. That's actually enough people for a volleyball team.
Really?
Besides, even if one of our persons dies, we can still field a basketball team. Wait, what? What are you talking about, real?
Never mind. Moving on. No, I was saying more of, like, do we have enough to, like, for two sides to play a full volleyball game?
No, but even then, like, if you want to, like, well, there's six, you can just split three and three.
Hey.
Okay. And that's, like, reverse positive thinking. Anyway, there's no time to be depressed. For the sake of everyone we've lost, we have to do our best. Can we stop all this group hug nonsense? We need to find out what everyone discovered. Fuck you, Byakuya. Fuck you.
Yeah.
All right.
I checked all the windows on the fifth floor, front and back. That used to be kind of Sakura's job, but are you triggered now?
No, I'm just eating.
You said you were gonna save that till after the stream.
I'm hungry.
Anyways, no dice. There's no metal plates on all of the windows, just like everywhere else. I mean, there were metal plates everywhere.
You did it, baby. Yes, beach volleyball only needs 2v2. Oh.
Correct.
I thought. Huh. Okay.
Which means no chance of escape on the fifth floor either.
Well,
when I look around, I realize something about the layout of the school.
Reaction!
What exactly did you notice about the layout of the school?
Just a second.
You took a good look around on the fifth floor yourself, didn't you, Makoto?
Huh? Why'd you ask?
So then.
Because if you did, you would have noticed that the fifth floor is lacking something something every floor has.
Oh, stairs!
Cool.
Something on the other floors, but not on the fifth floor? Are you talking about stairs? There aren't any stairs leading up from the fifth floor. That's what you're talking about, right? Does that mean the fifth floor is the end?
Correct.
We're finally starting to get a clear picture of the school.
Yeah, but there's also still that locked stairway, though. From that's not in the school, it's like the outside of the school. All that's left now is to solve the underlying mystery.
But
but that's the hardest part.
Okay. Even if it's hard, we still gotta do it.
Yeah, Hina's right. Everything will be okay as long as we work together. I'm sure we'll make it out of this. No, I'm sure. We absolutely will make it out, no matter what it takes.
Alright, I'm gonna go for Telco. What?
I wish Telco would talk.
Wait, what?
I said I wish Telco would talk.
Well, she's going to as soon as Byakuya lets her. Hey, Byakuya, it seems like Telco wants to say something.
What?
So, why are you asking me?
Hey.
Well, because you told her to zip it or whatever. Ah, I forgot about that. Jesus, man! I know you like torturing her, but come on!
What a sadist.
He really is. Well, Toko, if you want to envelop us all your prudent breath, I won't stop you. Go ahead.
You honor me, master. And don't worry, I took care of the odor problem. Oh my god, she's so into this.
She's super into this.
Seriously, you're just gonna take it?
What the heck?
Shut up. And don't interrupt when Master and me are talking. Okay, so what did you want to tell us? God, she's the best gift for this. Well, when I was in the classroom on the fifth floor and something caught my attention. It was this.
Whoa, isn't that like a combat knife or whatever?
Yeah, it is.
Baby, why would you know this? A knife?
My dad likes knives.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, that thing is huge. It's like a Rambo size.
I was gonna get upset if you couldn't pronounce Rambo.
Sorry, I'm still stuck on the stutters right now.
I'm proud of you.
What?
It's a survival knife of some type.
Told you. I use a sword.
Pine corn. Hello. Welcome to the stream.
A Bowie knife, yes. Actually, bye.
Okay, bye.
Well, that was short-lived, I guess. Anyways.
But what was it doing in the classroom?
Well,
how would I know? Oh.
Very suspicious.
Intense sweating it. Intense.
What are you going to use that knife for? What are you planning to do to us?
I'm not gonna do anything. I just picked it up and I didn't want to leave the knife just laying around. Uh-huh.
I mean, that's a relevant point, though.
How about that?
Yeah. Dude, someone can just get murdered if you just leave it there.
Okay, to be fair, the giant Venus flytrap is also a screaming kind of thing where it's just like, yeah. That's
yeah, but no one thought to cut it down.
Well, no, you don't need to cut down the Venus flytrap. I mean more of like you could throw someone into the Venus flytrap and murder them. Yeah, see. And like Monokuma said, you could basically recycle anything. Even people.
I'd rather have it lay around in the hands of a... I mean, I'd rather have it laying around than in the hands of a serial killer.
Oh, you mean the penis flytrap? God damn it. I didn't notice that.
Don't compare me to her. I'm nothing like her. I don't want you to.
Except for your agreement on calling him master.
Listen, Mario Kart, shut up. Just continue. I already finished saying that.
Okay, go. You already finished that?
Yeah. You were listening.
Yes, I was listening to you.
Now that we have a knife, what are we gonna do with it?
Just put it in the kitchen to replace the other knife that someone else used to try to blame, Makoto.
We can't let Makoto, let Toko keep it.
Shut up.
That's for sure. We don't know what she might do.
What's your problem?
I don't want it anyways. It's too dangerous.
Okay.
what to do.
So then,
why don't you hang on to Makoto? I was gonna say Monokuma.
Because you want him to be Monokuma. I knew it. Makoto's the real Monokuma.
Huh? Me? Oh yeah, I totally trust Makoto to take care of it.
Okay.
Then that's that.
Jesus Christ, everyone.
Everyone trusts him.
Hold on, don't I get a say?
It's all clear.
It just shows how much they trust you. You should do as they ask. Are you sure it's trust? I feel like they're just using me.
Sounds like it.
Okay, so here you go, Makoto.
I mean, Toko trusts us.
The knife goes step.
Na.
They're acting like I already said yes.
Fine. I guess there's nothing I can do. I'll just keep it in my desk drawer for now.
Anyways, that's all I wanted to say.
Hey, Toko.
Yeah, they're punching someone. Do I still have that breath? Aww. Sorry.
That's fine.
You made a valuable discovery. Good job.
I meant Master praise me, not please me.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? See? Master just praise me? Hey, good for you. God, I didn't mean to say
Oh no.
Me.
Oh no.
I'm dreaming. I must be dreaming. Aw. that I would ever experience such a dream. Oh my god.
Oh no. She's so wet right now. I'm so terrible. Say it.
I feel so strange. So strange. I'm really strange. Oh no. Oh my god. No.
Whatever I look at Toko these days, it makes me feel sad.
I cry every time.
I cry every time as I see Toko look like she just came.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, there's a big garden up in the fifth floor, and I found more than one thing to be worried about. A large stupidly large plant, a chicken coop, and I know what you're gonna say, but it's a tool shed. Reaction! Monokuma said it's called the Monokuma flower. Even touching it seems dangerous, so we have to be careful.
You're serious?
It's totally a man-eating plant. I'm pretty sure it's different from the one... the one that lives in the pipe, though. God, no!
He just made a reference to Mario, and I'm just upset.
Anyway, that thing must be... God damn it, baby.
Sorry.
It's heavy metal version of Mario.
Anyway, that thing must benefit from the sprinkler system as much as anything else in there.
Oh yeah, apparently the sprinklers come on every morning at 7:30 on the dot.
Hmm. Yeah, remember that? You don't want to get drenched and catch a cold.
Yeah.
Well,
what? What'd you say, baby? You sound far away. Hello?
Yeah, right now. Anyways. You don't have to worry. They say idiots never catch colds, you know. Sorry, one that was talking to me.
Coming from the one that talks. Coming from the one that's talking.
Of course not, because idiots never get wet.
I think you're thinking of ducks.
I'm I'm starting to worry about you, Hira. Can you tell me what 10 plus 10 is? 21.
Heck! Hey, come on! You don't always have to call me dumb. I may have been held back 3 times, but that doesn't make me stupid. But if it will make you happy, I'll answer your dumb question. So, what was the question again?
Don't worry about it, you just answered it.
Shit. Kinda proved a point now.
Hey.
My concern is about the bio lab. That was the only place on the fifth floor we couldn't access.
Which is cool.
The bio lab, huh? I wonder what's in there.
Could it be... If there were, like, a cliche horror game, it'd be some kind of creature. The final boss. Or tyrant.
God damn it, of course he'd make a Resident Evil reference. 10 plus 10 is 2 ones and 2 zeros, duh. God damn it.
We're not in a horror game, though.
Either way, we don't need to worry about it at all. I mean, at the moment. Don't bother thinking about something that can't be understood, no matter how much you think about it.
Naturally.
Your tiny brains can only do so much, so focus on utilizing them efficiently.
I don't really like how you said it. Well, what you said is probably right.
What?
No, how I said it is right, too. Fuck you, Byakuya, you're such a cunt. Whatever, Byakuya Togami. By the way, did any of you find it? Damn it, Shiny Darkness Step. The other strange room on the fifth floor, well, no strange, is a massive understatement. The smell of flesh and fat and blood. The white outlines of countless corpses. And it was more dreadful than anything I've encountered here so far.
What the hell are you talking about?
The smell itself was horrific. Far beyond any murder case. Everybody's smell concentrated.
God, I'm glad I didn't see that. I feel like I'm gonna barf just hearing you describe it.
But I mean, what the hell happened in that room?
So in other words...
I only can think of one thing. A large group of people died right there in that room.
A bunch of people were killed in there?
They all died. Spread eagle. Don't worry about it.
Stop, seriously, I'm gonna throw up.
It can't be.
Perhaps that's what they meant by... the biggest, most awful, most tragic events in human history.
Huh? You're thinking the same thing then. My theory is, the mass murder that took place in that room is the incident that's said to have happened 1 year ago. The awful scene in that room, that was the tragedy that happened a year ago?
In other words...
Precisely. The tragedy is another name for the genocide of the student body of the Hope's Peak Academy. If that's true...
It's all clear now.
That would explain...
Hold on. Just wait, hold on. I'm grabbing a piece of cake.
Why are you getting a piece of cake? Why'd you interrupt me to stop?
Because they brought me cake and I wanted cake, so...
Oh my god, go get the cake.
I got cake.
Oh my cake. God.
Okay, I didn't know why I stopped you.
I love you, but god damn it.
I just felt the necessary, you know what?
Necessary to just to say it. Necessary to stop me. Anyways, that would explain why Hope's Peak was forced to close its doors.
Hey. I mean, I guess that all makes sense, but It's all just so awful.
Not just awful, but super awfully awful.
Why do you have to emphasize the word awful? God damn it. They're right. It's beyond awful. It's terrible, tragic, helpless. But still, how's it not one of us ever heard about something like that happening? Does that mean they really did cover it up? Alright, we have one more. Oh, okay, technically two more because... this. Chickens! It was necessary, don't question it. Okay. I guess I won't question it. I will never question you again, Blue. Baba. Babu. Blanky Blue. Na-na-na, cluck, 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 cluck. There are a bunch of chickens in the coop, right? That's right, five chickens.
I love chickens.
Hey, look, there's you, Blanky Boo.
I love chickens. That's reason to be big and fat, and then we can find, and then we can make fried chicken for... oh, or barbecue.
Oh, she was thinking about murdering them, not keeping them as pets.
Chicken nuggets.
Baby, stop it.
Oh, or how about raw? Because there's nothing fresher than raw, right?
What is wrong with you and her? I'm pretty sure that'd kill you. Well, we have one more thing for Yossi. Five chickens. Ha, thanks, Count. Well, we have the tool shed. You noticed it too, huh? That pickaxe.
What?
Huh? What about the pickaxe? Well, there was a pickaxe in the tool shed. And the words crazy diamond had been carved into the handle. Haven't we seen that phrase somewhere before?
Crazy diamond. Yeah, that does seem kind of familiar, I think.
It's true.
I don't just think I know. We've definitely seen that phrase before. Huh? Huh? Where?
Oh, that's it.
That's right. Wrong person. Sorry. I got ahead of myself because I was eating cake.
You did it, baby.
I was eating cake.
Oh!
Sorry.
That's Mondo!
Oh my god.
It was on Mondo's uniform on the back of his jacket. His jacket said the same thing, right? Crazy Diamond!
I see.
You're absolutely right.
What? Hold it. But why would that be on a pickaxe in the garden?
Could it be?
Mondo must have stuck it in there and done it, right?
Not possible.
We didn't have access to the garden until today.
That's right!
Then maybe Mondo brought it with him when he first came here, and Monokuma confiscated it.
Okay, there's a lot of things wrong with that. One, why the fuck would he have a pickaxe at a school?
Because he's a delinquent.
He's a biker delinquent! Not a fucking...
Oh?
Then he would have something like a baseball bat. Even though... I know that's
your
a trope.
Your argument's invalid.
Your argument's invalid. Oh. Good old Kuwabara hair. Yeah, man. Yeah, Kuwabara. Anyways. Whatever the reason, that's what stuck out to me. I mean, stuck out to me in the tool shed. The pickaxe connected to Mondo. Well, what stuck out to me wasn't the pickaxe at all. Huh? Then what did?
Yo!
What I noticed was the lawnmower. I think maybe we can use it to call for help. What?
What?
What? What?
How are you gonna call for help with the lawnmower?
What?
My thoughts exactly.
I don't know, maybe I can use it to make crop circles or something. Why is he so abnormally stupid?
Like, why is he just freakishly stupid?
Yeah, that's it. I'm gonna make crop circles.
Well,
and we can use it to call for help.
What the heck's happened to you?
He's so desperate.
Seriously. You weren't like this in the beginning, though.
He's desperate.
Well, back then, my personality hadn't quite solidified yet.
I didn't think it was possible, but I'm more disappointed in you than I have ever been.
Yeah, but that's not saying much. Well, I think that's all the new information we have for now.
Yo!
So, now what do we do?
Make crop circle.
What? Stop. We're not making a crop.
He was always like this.
Yes, he was.
Starting today, you're all under my command. Jesus Christ, he is going for the whole master shtick. But before we proceed, I need to figure something out.
Yes, you didn't hear that, right?
No, I heard it.
Oh, you did hear it.
Yay. Fucking piece of shit.
No way.
Jeez, how cocky can you be? You're gonna bust through the ceiling if your heads get any bigger. If your head get any bigger.
So, what is it that you want to figure out?
Kyoko's identity. Huh? That's...
Well...
Oh, you, like, totally read my line. Just like how I read yours.
What? Where?
What? Wait, I thought you were reading her line.
No, I just read Byakuya's.
Oh, Kyoko's identity, but Kyoko is Kyoko, right?
Yes, but who is she? She's literally right there.
She is clearly a government spy. I would agree with that, actually.
The rest of us have a clear, definable reason for having been selected to attend Hope's Peak Academy. Hina's the ultimate swimming pro. Hiro's the ultimate clairvoyant. Even Mikoto is the ultimate lucky student.
The ultimate generic student, should I say.
Fuck you! More unlucky than lucky these days, but... So what about you? Can anyone tell me what she is? Now that you mention it, she's never told us.
Well, Kyoko doesn't really like talking about herself anyways, right?
Well, she is hot, and that's all she needs. God damn it.
That's not a valid reason.
Not me. I didn't say. Shiny Darkness did. Not me.
I mean, it is, but it isn't a valid reason.
Shush.
Moving on. It's not a matter of what she likes or dislikes. It's a matter of trust. Can you trust someone who is willing to reveal her true identity?
Listen, Batman doesn't reveal his identity to every single... She's primarily a love interest. True.
We need to avoid raising any more unnecessary suspicion. So, Kyoko, it's time for you to tell like you told us.
I can't...
That's bullshit. You know this.
What? Why won't you tell us?
Wrong.
Sorry, that's what I feel like she does with her hands. When no one's looking, she's like...
I just think...
Oh, no, I didn't read that!
Oh, just say it.
I said I can't. You, like, totally skipped something. I don't know what's going on.
She just says, I can't, and then it's like... Oh. Fuck it.
What do you mean?
So...
Because... I don't remember.
No. Don't do this trope. Not this trope. She has amnesia.
What?
I have no memory of what I am.
Oh, god damn it.
Sorry, I'm still thinking about the other girl.
Stop it. Stop trying to imitate Toko. She's stupid.
You have no memory? You mean...
Amnesia?
There's always one character that has this. Or in some things. Whatever.
What?
Oh, you know what? Actually, that kind of made me mad. A sleeper agent. Stop. We're not going Captain America Winter Soldier. Anyways.
If I thought you had a sense of humor, I would say you were joking. But if this is a joke, I'm not laughing.
This is very suspicious.
You can't be serious, right? Can right now, can you?
Stop it. Stop me.
I knew you wouldn't believe me. Sorry, it's funny.
She's Batman.
Every time I see her, I think, oh, that's why I didn't say anything.
However,
but it doesn't matter. Either way, the truth will make itself clear before we're done.
What? So you have no intentions of telling us? Then I can no longer stand by and do nothing.
Hey.
What are you gonna do? Poor Trudy.
Why are you giggling, you goof?
Sorry.
Stop it.
Nothing so barbaric as that. I'll simply limit your options. I can't allow you to engage in any further suspicious activities.
What?
Limit my options?
Just give up.
Give me the key to your room.
Hey.
If she gives you... Stop. But if she gives you her room key, she is a psycho murderer. It all makes sense now. No, it's not.
She can't go to sleep in her room. She'll be breaking school regulations. Hey. I know why he wants to see. Hey.
The D. Anyways, if she doesn't want that, she'll talk. It's easy. All she has to do is tell us about herself. Just hold on. A threat like that.
That's fine.
What? Fine. I understand.
Good. You're finally in the mood for conversation. Without saying a word, Kyoko walked right up to Bianca Yan, held out her room key to him.
It can't be.
You damn fool. Why do you refuse to talk?
Because...
Fool!
You fool!
Whether I want to or not, I can't. All I can do is keep telling you that.
So,
maybe she really did lose her memory.
If you really think about it, it doesn't sound totally impossible. This is the worst school ever. But only the worst stuff happens, right? Amnesia would fit in, right? Would fit right in.
The worst school where only the worst things happen. Do you really mean that?
Huh?
Hey.
Can you really be sure that life here has been filled with only the worst things?
What do you mean?
Perhaps I've said too much.
Kyoko then turned her back on us, and without a word began to walk away.
Come on.
What do you think you're going? Goodbye. Where do you think you're going?
Don't worry, I'm not going to do anything to harm any of you.
Those were her last words as she left. Kyoko's last words. The dining hall was silent. The only sound was the door opening and closing as Kyoko left the room.
What the heck?
What's her deal?
But...
I think you went too far by taking her room key like that. For her? That wasn't far enough. Oh, stop it. Stop it. Oh.
Jesus.
Oh my god. Or maybe she wants to get off on attention. I can't believe her. She's enjoying it. Really? 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 Getting yelled at? Really?
Stop talking.
Just look at yourself.
You're getting noisy again, Toko. Hey.
Come on.
Sorry, I can still hear you. The sound of you breathing, of your heart beating, It grates on me.
Hey!
Are you telling her to die? I mean, I know how you feel, but... But what's Kyoko gonna do now? Plus, the situation... It's just like before. It's no different from when everyone started accusing Sakura. And I'm no different either. I still can't stop anyone.
Babu.
No.
What? What the hell? Why are you yelling all of a sudden?
Cause, I mean...
Cause, look!
It's you! How long have you been standing there?
I'm very, very angry!
I'm like eating kind of like the caught me off guard.
At the thief. Yes, that's right. I'm very sad to have to tell you there's a thief in your midst. Huh? Thief in your midst.
What?
Hey! My precious! They stole it!
Your precious?
Your teacher had such faith in you. This is how you repay me? With betrayal?
Oh, there's voicing, so that's why I didn't say anything.
Reality is filled with so much hardship, isn't it? No. I mean, no wonder people will run away with their fantasies.
What the heck is your precious?
Shut up! I hope all of you get stuck in a hiring freeze and...
In a hiring freeze? Whatever.
Stuck in a hiring freeze and die penniless on the streets!
What the heck?
And he's gone. What the heck was that all about?
So,
he said something about his precious getting stolen.
My precious.
Does anyone have any idea what that might mean? That she stole it?
It's likely has something to do with Kyoko. Huh? Who other than her would be willing to be able to steal something from Monokuma? Did Kyoko really steal something from Monokuma? If that's true, what was it? And why would she do that?
His virginity.
Stop. Uh-oh.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially nighttime. Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked, and entry at that point is strictly prohibited. Okay then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night.
Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
We need to get out of here.
You know?
We can talk more, this more tomorrow, and about Kyoko.
Okay, anyways.
However, after what just happened with Monokuma and Kyoko, I feel like there's something in the air.
You have her key.
True, and he's kind of being a douche about it.
I would suggest you take extra precaution tonight. Stay in your rooms and don't go wandering around.
No. Not like we need you to tell us that.
Goodbye.
Well then, let's disperse. I'll see you tomorrow.
Tomorrow. That's all I heard.
Shut up. I was eating. My mushroom.
Yeah, okay. Following his lead, each of us went back to our rooms.
Oh, that's right. I need to put the knife that I got from Toko.
Put away the knife that Toko gave me.
I think the safest place for it will be in my desk drawer.
really? That's like totally the safest place.
But, well, to be fair, these rooms are locked, except for whenever Kyoko was able to get into his room. And that was in the last chapter. Which, again, that's weird. How was she able to get into Makoto's locked room? No, she doesn't. Stop. Is Kyoko really gonna be okay? She can't get into her room. What's she gonna do? Isn't there something I can do?
You better not let her in your house. I mean, room.
Something I can... Eh? Dots. Dots. Eh? As I opened my eyes, I realized I'd fallen asleep without realizing it. But more important...
It's midnight.
Did I hear the doorbell? Nah. Who the fuck? Oh, it's Kyoko. Kyoko-chan?
Hey.
I'll be waiting for you in the dressing room. Oh!
What?
Sorry.
You know, wait, did you say see you there?
Yeah.
Oh, I did.
See you there. Alright, let's see that.
Hey, wait, Kyoko! Without acknowledging me, Kyoko disappeared in the depths of the darkened hallway.
She's like a ghost.
I know we're not supposed to be going out during nighttime, but I can't just go. I mean, not go.
Can't just go.
Cannot just go. Shut up. Well,
hey.
Sorry for asking you to meet me so late.
It's not asking. It was more of like forcing me to go to one direction. You piece of shit.
I mean, he didn't have to go.
Again. Well, he's the only... She wants the D. It's okay, I'm used
Correct.
To it.
Indeed.
So then...
Well then, let me get straight to the point.
It's something you can't talk about in front of the surveillance cameras, right? So, does that mean... Does this have to have something to do with whatever it is you stole from Monokuma? That... Monokuma told us earlier that someone had stolen something from him. Crazy. Was it you?
Indeed.
That's right.
So I was right. But what did you steal?
So...
His virginity.
Stop.
He stole this.
Key? But looking at it, I could tell it wasn't just any key. It was shaped like Monokuma. It's probably the only key of its kind on Earth. Unless they start selling it at stores today! Go to this website! That's gonna be in the link in the description! Just kidding, that's false advertisement. It was a joke. He's... Where did you get it?
So...
From the headmaster room.
You did it. What? You snuck into the headmaster's room? But wasn't it locked?
However,
the lock was broken.
What? What?
Correct. It was Sakura. She did it for us.
Sakura did do something nice for us. She did that for us. I'm actually getting a little bit tearing up. It kind of made me sad. She did?
Indeed.
Remember what she said in her note? I'm not going to just lay down it. I will fight you. Dun dun dun.
So Sakura broke into the headmaster's room for us?
That's right.
That's right. So that we could uncover whatever secrets may lie hidden within.
She did that? For us. She violated the school regulations to help us. I'm not crying, you're crying. I am crying! That made me a little bit teary-eyed.
Stop
she actually
crying.
Shut up! I'm a little bit teary right now because she did something. She literally broke a school rule that would actually cause her to be murdered.
She already decided to die, so her last act was to defy the rules of this place.
Indeed. Sakura.
I noticed the room was open after class trial was over yesterday. But if I did just stroll into the room, Monokuma would have noticed right away, which is why I used you as a decoy.
That's fucked up.
So you asked me to meet you at the data center in order to...
Correct. I wanted you to draw Monokuma's attention. I took that opportunity to sneak into the headmaster's room and as a result, I found this key.
Okay, where is that key? Wow. Then, what you told me about yesterday, did that come from the headmaster's room too?
Mukuro Ikusaba, the 16th student, lying hidden somewhere in this school. The one they call the ultimate despair.
The ultimate of
Watch
despair.
Out for her.
Did you find out about this Mukuro Ikusaba while you were there?
I did find a file in the headmaster's room that talked about her, yes. I don't know all the details yet, but... Sorry. One thing I do know is that... I don't know how to say her name.
Mukuro.
Mukuro Ikusaba is dangerous.
Dangerous?
In other words...
She may very well be the mastermind.
Mastermind. But didn't Ultra Ego say that the headmaster was probably the mastermind?
Wrong.
No, the headmaster isn't the mastermind. I'm sure of that.
What?
I don't have proof yet, but I have no doubt I'm right. Because she's always right.
Not always.
Yeah. You can't see me, but I did the quotation mark.
You're such a brat. Anyways, to make such a strong statement without proof, that's not like Kyoko at all. But if it isn't the headmaster, does that mean Mukuro Ikusaba really could be the mastermind?
Anyway, this key is one big opportunity we've been waiting for to get on our hands. You think it opens the bio lab?
There's only two places I would think at, like, the very likely situation. Since it's a since it's designed to be a key for Monokuma, I would only think of the data lab as the plausible place, like, one of the two places. The bio lab is the second likely place it would work.
I mean, it kind of sounds like it would fit there because the bio lab was locked.
I mean, so is the data lab. The data lab was also locked, though.
That is true. Now that we've grasped it, we can't let it go, can we?
Sure, I mean, what's this key even unlock?
So...
I don't know yet, which is why... I need you to draw Monokuma's attention again, while I go find out.
So I'm gonna have to run around in circles and be like, "Witness me!" And I'm gonna put spray paint in my mouth. Name that.
Jesus.
Fine, all over my face. I guess that's the proper way to put it. Because I was trying to make a reference to Mad Max.
Anyways, wait. So you're planning into sneaking back in again? You can't. It's way too dangerous. You want me to draw his attention, but we don't actually know there's just one mastermind, right? If there's more than one person watching us?
Is that right?
But they didn't catch on last night, right?
Maybe we just got lucky.
Okay. Or maybe the mastermind can't monitor us and control Monokuma at the same time. Oh my god, I just
You're such a brat.
I spit on myself, I'm sorry.
Ew.
know.
Gross.
It's not like I did that on purpose, though. Like I said, we didn't get caught last night. But as you said, maybe it's just pure luck. Because you are the ultimate luck.
Shush, we're not talking about this.
The ultimate generic person.
Fuck you.
Which is why we're gonna run the experiment one more time. And if we succeed, and if we're successful again, then what may have just been lucky guess will be proven true.
As Kyoko talked, she was calm and collected as ever. I couldn't help but just stand there and listen.
Hey.
If it's true, then the mastermind can't watch us and control Monokuma at the same time.
Well, it can't be 100% true about that, though.
Then there would have to be a period of time where the mastermind is vulnerable.
That would be nighttime, actually.
That is true. What we need to do is find out for sure. If that's actually true, then we can exploit it.
And if we can...
Until they catch on.
Maybe, but... No matter what the reward, the risk is just too high. When I think of what might happen if we fail...
Why is that?
I don't think you need to worry all that much, after all.
With minimal restriction, you are free to explore Hope's Peak Academy at your discretion.
No restrictions have been placed on our efforts to solve the mystery, am I wrong? Even though I took this key, I didn't break any rules as far as I can tell.
But if the mastermind decides to do something, all the rules in the world wouldn't matter. He could just kill us all without a second thought.
I see.
In that case, even if the plans fail, we'll still be able to prove or disprove that hypothesis.
What?
Correct.
In the moment of a crisis, will the mastermind break their own rules? Or... adhere to them no matter what.
In other
matter
words.
What?
Oh, man. Sorry, I was staring at my turtle. In other words, we gain something whether we can succeed or not. Now, there's no reason not to do it, right?
I mean, I guess.
But
if you spend all your time trying to avoid danger, you'll never move forward.
So inspirational.
So inspirational.
Okay, no voice.
We know the danger, but if the risk means solving the mystery, we have no choice.
Hey.
Am I wrong?
Mm-hmm. At that moment, I finally realized I'd never seen the slightest hint of fear or despair in Kyoko's eyes. Her gaze was firmly fixed on the mystery ahead. The enemy standing before us, and with that in view, she just smiled.
I can't imagine how I feel, and I wouldn't if I could.
Then Kyoko took something from her coat pocket and held it out to me. Huh? What's this?
It's true.
Consider it a symbol of my determination. Don't open it yet. Only open it if something ever to happen to me.
No! No!
Does that mean it probably tells about her, like her information?
Of what she knows and what she was looking into while everyone else was looking around these murders. All
and
the times...
what she was the ultimate thing.
Yes. If something happens,
she's predicting that something will happen in this situation.
However,
most likely, I'm not planning on dying, but if there's a chance of that, and death without meaning is unappealing.
Hey.
Please, I want you to hold on to it for me.
Fine, I'll hold on to it just because you asked me to. But I'm gonna give it back at some point, you can be sure of that.
Indeed.
Yes, of course.
Hey.
Oh, and one more thing. Sorry.
Okay. Goober.
You can't tell anyone else about what I've discovered.
You're such a brat. Sure. Because there's a chance the mastermind might find out, right?
Indeed.
Well, there's that too.
Huh? You mean there's something else?
Well,
it's nothing. Forget I said anything.
I can't just forget that easily.
So then.
I can. I have amnesia.
Shut up. You're a goober.
Okay, then. Shall we begin?
Makoto.
I'm counting on you, Makoto.
I love you too, Kyoko. Kiss me.
I believe in you.
Kiss me, Kyoko. I just have to get Monokuma's attention, right? Well, I'll give it my best shot.
Goodbye.
Run around, go little. Going on ahead. The rest is up to you.
Okay. Her curt goodbye was no different from any other time. Pervert. No, I'm not. Okay, I am, but no. And like every other time, she moved at a brisk pace as she left. What wasn't like every other time, was the sudden knot I felt in my stomach as I watched her walk away. No, everything's gonna be fine. I know it. Because it's Kyoko. Talking to myself helped shake off some of my anxiety.
I have like a knot in my stomach because I know something's gonna happen to her now.
And then I got to work. Witness me! Okay, let's do this. Hey, Monokuma, you can see me, right? Get out of here. I got a bone to pick with you. Then, a few moments later...
Monokuma appears!
Well, this is a surprise. You're being the one to call me out.
Hey,
by the way... Huh?
Most suspicious.
What were you and Kyoko doing, up to? Going to the bathhouse? Just the two of you in the middle of the night. Definitely a hot and steamy moment, wouldn't you say?
Oh my god.
So wet and warm. I bet you guys.
Removed to confirm with local and international censorship laws.
All over her, didn't you? Not gonna talk, huh? Sure, I get it. Well, whatever. Unlike you, I have absolutely no interest in late-night bath scenes. Because I like to maintain a healthy life of observation far away from X-rated exploits.
Oh, that was so bad. Oh, so is that why there's no surveillance cameras in the bathrooms?
Wow. Bullseye!
Or is it maybe because the lens gets all fogged up and you can't see anything anyway? Sounds like that's the bullseye to me.
You need something?
Anyway, you went all the trouble to get me out here. So,
get out of here.
Now, what do you want?
Oh, well, there's just something I want to confirm with
say
you.
What?
Whether I'm the mademoiselle or the... or dude fella?
Actually...
But in the Bear Kingdom, there is no male or female.
Actually, there is.
What?
Seriously?
My entire
what am I?
Existence!
My entire existence!
This is kind of
that's enough. I get stuck. I'll get stuck if I think about it too much. So, what do you really want to ask me?
Oh, well, you told us earlier that your precious had been stolen. What's this precious of yours?
What are you thinking?
Listen, I'm sure this is a silly question. No way it's possibly and all, and possibly and all. Is that seriously what you dragged me out here to ask me? You gotta be kidding me! You gotta be 100 megaton freaking kidding me! You're not gonna ask something useful like how to get the best honey or the Urocene breeding tips?
I'm not even gonna try to pronounce that. That makes running out of the bathroom yelling witness me even better.
Yes. This is just crazy! You're all pubescent teen boys and as nutty as you.
What the heck?
God, you're so annoying! Fine, I'll tell you. It was a key and a dot
star 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 star.
That's it!
Wait. What was that second thing?
It's a blank, stupid! A secret! Fill it in yourself! Making me drudge all the way out here for that. I'd like to see what's going on in that brain of yours. And next time you summon me for something stupid, I'll open up your skull and find out.
Dropping more than a few swear words, Monokuma stormed off. I hoped I kept him distracted long enough. Now all I can do is wait and hope Kyoko makes it out okay. No, she'll be fine. It's Kyoko after all. I'm sure she's fine, right? I went back to my room and laid down, doing my best to settle my nerve and get back to sleep.
Monokuma Theater!
There's so much junk in this room.
Monokuma Theater!
Wait, there's images in there.
Toonsoft Company Limited.
Oh, and he's voicing this. What? It's a 3D Sakura! Baby, you see this?
Yes.
But I don't understand. Okay, this is the coolest thing that's came out of this game. I would play this. I would play this Musou game. What? What is going on? Sakura's Revenge, the game the world has been waiting for. Unfortunately, development has been canceled. Of course, if enough people buy DanganRonpa, who knows, buy copies with all your friends. Fuck you, Monokuma, you're a dick.
This super stylish, super fashionable game was canceled during development? But they'll start backing up again if DanganRonpa sells well.
Then you guys have to recommend it to your friends, too!
Fuck you! I'm so upset. I actually would want to play that game if Sakura was able to do that. Like a Musou DanganRonpa. Baby?
Good morning,
Witness
everyone!
Me.
It is now 7 a.m. And nighttime is officially over! Time to rise and shine!
Shit, I just realized what time it is.
Yeah.
Get ready to greet another beautiful
day! Yeah, you do
that.
I'll be reading out loud. I'm gonna eat this cookie.
My body feels so heavy this morning. It must be because I was up so late last night. Anyway, I need to get to the dining hall. Leave the area? Yeah.
Okay, I finished your
job. Well, yeah, babe.
What?
You're 1 minute late, Makoto. How do you explain this? Sorry. I'm not feeling so great today.
What's your problem?
You're a brat.
You really think that's you really think a tired excuse like that is gonna work?
Yes. Huh? Are you allowed to talk again? I don't recall giving you permission. What a Yasuhiro, you're a piece of shit.
since the day has passed, it might be reset. Sorry, please don't hate me, but whatever my punishment is, I'll accept it, you weirdo.
Master.
I'll hang up a sign from my neck saying, bad...
There?
Bad girl, I'll clean your bathroom with my paper. That's disgusting. She's probably gonna stick that back in her mouth.
Yeah, she would too. If you stop making disgusting comments like that, maybe I can forgive you.
Thank you. I won't make any more disgusting comments. I promise, shut up, you like it.
She's lying. She'll do it again.
If I do, you can stuff my mouth full of trash. Oh my god.
She's beautiful.
As long as it's you, no one else. I don't mind. God, she's still weird.
It's no use. She's disgusting to the bone.
So,
anyways, where's Kyoko? I haven't seen her from this morning.
Could it be? Not cool. Oh. This is the worst than being late for lunch, for a date, or your wedding, for anything.
Maybe
she's mad about what happened yesterday and she's not gonna show up anymore. Aw.
No.
This not.
I can't tell the others why Kyoko might not be here. The best thing to do right now is just keep quiet.
Very strange.
Whatever her reason, I'm curious to know what she is doing. I know she's not in her room, so...
You know?
No, yeah. You still have her key, right?
What's this?
Ah, are you looking for Miss... Kirigiri?
What? Ah! What do you want now?
Hey!
Right? You're wondering where Miss Kirigiri is, right?
Do you know where she is?
Well, it's hard to say.
Huh? You don't know either?
What?
It's because he doesn't know. That's why he's here. To try and prod us for information.
Uh-huh. Hey, don't you hate it when you ask someone their favorite movie is, and they name some indie bullcrap?
This is very suspicious.
I feel like I'm getting whiplash. That's the way he changes the subject like that.
Thank goodness. It looks like Monokuma really didn't notice. So I guess our plan went off just fine last night. Which could mean...
Hey.
Oh, is it like speaking?
It's a flashback. So you gotta make it sound echoey. Just say same time echoey, whatever.
Wait, what?
She was like,
maybe the mastermind cat monitored us and controlled Monokuma at the same time.
Time. Could she have been right about that?
Hey!
So, was I right? You're looking for Miss Kirigiri. Any idea where she might have gone?
We have no idea.
And even if we did know, why would we tell you?
We're serious! My shizzle, my nizzle.
I see. Well, fine. Whatever. I don't even care anymore. Sayonara, suckers!
As soon as he was gone, we all glanced around at each other.
So, what was that just now? Does that mean Monokuma doesn't know where she is either?
It would seem that way.
You know?
Where the heck could have she... I mean, she could have gone.
Do you think we should all go look for her?
How would you suggest we approach that task? Even Monokuma can't seem to locate her.
Very suspicious.
Yeah. How can we not know where she is?
Yeah, totally.
So strange.
Kyoko must have used the key to sneak into some unknown part of the school. But somewhere even Monokuma wouldn't notice? Where could it be?
We spent the rest of the breakfast talking about where Kyoko could have been. I mean, could have gone. Afterwards, we returned to our rooms. All right. Now for the good part. Phew. Breakfast didn't help me feel any more upbeat, that's for sure. I feel like this is more than just me staying up late last night. All right, free time.
Free to play.
Free, let's play. Banana. Alright. I think, maybe you're good for, like, a little bit more? Or you want to call it?
Yeah. No, I'm good for a little bit more.
Alright, we'll probably call it around, like, 220, 230. Sound fair?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, that's my time. Fine. Alright, okay, so. Alright, so with the remaining people, we can't talk to Kyoko right now because she's gone missing. But the main question is, who should we hang out with this free time? We'll only be allowed to hang out with two people.
Decisions.
So we could talk to Byakuya or Toko, Yasuhiro, or Aoi. Since those are the only people left right now, we only have four people that just legitimately talk with. Meanwhile, Kyoko is missing. So who do you think we should hang out with, Babu? Because we'll be allowed to talk to one more person. To the dynamic duo right there, to the world's biggest idiot. He's the world's ultimate idiot, to be fair.
To the donut? Sorry.
You want the donut?
Want the donut?
Eat that donut. So Aoi it is then. Let's go talk to her. Wait, what time is it for you? You know daylight savings ended, right? Hey.
It's 12:49.
Hey, it is.
AM, yeah. What time is it for you?
I mean, my clock's showing it's 1:49 right now.
You're like an hour behind. You're an hour ahead of me?
Yeah, I'm Central and you're like... Shit.
I don't know. Let's just continue.
Sunday. Oh, began at 2 a.m. Oh, wait. And is that. Oh, so right now it's 12? Or am I being stupid?
It's 12:50 for me.
Oh. Oh, alright, let's talk to Aoi. We'll be chan. Are you on the East Coast? Because it's 1:50 for me. Yeah. Wait, aren't you on the East Coast, love?
I don't know.
Because I know I'm in the...
What is El Paso?
It's past Central. It's... It is mountain time, actually. So you have mountain time, love. That's why it's 12. 12:30.
Anyway, let's continue.
And plane tickets to go to El Paso is like 2 hours and 6 minutes, and it's $512. And driving there would be cheaper. Anyways, back to the video games.
Even if it's hard, you have to endure.
That's why she's the only one. Stop it.
Well,
that's a quote from the most famous marathon runner, Samuel Wanjida. endurance. What? That's for a person's endurance has a limit.
Ah.
It's just a wish in his lips.
Should I talk to Hina for a while? Spend some time with Hina.
Yeah.
I think we need a change of pace.
Where's your place?
Stop it. Stop it.
Anyways, finish this line.
And I think when I think change of pace.
You got it.
I can only think 50 laps in the pool.
Jesus Christ, no, please. I changed my pace with Hina in the pool. Hina and I grew a little closer today. Would you like to give Hina a present? Yes. It's called my dirk.
Damn, you stole what I was thinking.
Yeah, I thought so. You want to give her a nice black croissant?
Yeah.
Oh. The DSL hasn't changed. It's
pretty good.
Yeah, that's why. Oh, yeah, okay. So, let's give her the big old black croissant.
It sounds like it's actually pretty good, so yeah. Makoto, it's like you read my mind. I'm gonna cut this shit off. Stop it.
Metal Gear.
No.
Does that mean she liked it?
Yeah, she's blushing. Hey, Makoto?
Do you have a crush on me, Allie?
I'm so tired.
Yeah, you look pretty tired. What happened?
Well,
I woke up earlier than normal this morning, so I decided to do push-ups and sit-ups and squats it.
Ooh, do them nice squats.
I ended up doing 1,000 of each. Jesus. I can only do one of each. Not even one of each. I can only do half of one.
Baby, you could do like 10 bajillions.
No, I really can't. Well, I can only do half of one.
That would explain it.
Tired. So tired. I want something sweet.
I just gave you something sweet, you fool.
I want those things you get when you mix flour, sugar, butter, and eggs, and deep fry. You mean like a donut?
What is Hina looking for?
Donuts, 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 donuts.
That's literally impossible. Cookies, donuts. Wait, are you sure it's not a churro?
It's not I don't think it's a churro. Oh wait, yeah it is. You deep fry churros, don't you?
Yeah. Churros! Are you talking about churros?
Oh man, churros are good
no,
too.
No, fuck, now
aren't
I gotta redo this.
Like,
nope,
I told you. I told you it was a donut, but no.
Shut. We gotta do it again. I got this.
I didn't let anyone listen to me.
Baby, fight me.
I said donuts. You're like, no, that's impossible.
No, I was under the assumption I thought it wouldn't be that simple. Okay, she is a simple girl. Yes, I admit this. We all can agree Aoi's pretty simple. Even though she calls Yasuhiro stupid. And trust me, he's pretty stupid. But she could also think of something outside of donuts.
She gave her the croissant.
I'm gonna give her the croissant. I accidentally pressed the wrong button. Okay, so donuts. Oh, I know. You want some donuts, don't you?
Because you can't deep fry cookies.
You don't know that.
Don't tell anyone, but there's actually a bunch of frozen donuts in the warehouse.
What?
Really?
Okay.
Throw those in the microwave for a few seconds. Just imagine. Imagine the warm chewiness of that donut. Donut. You know what I'm saying, right? You'd eat the crap out of it, right?
You're the only one that would eat the crap out of it.
I would.
You really do love donuts, huh?
Just a second!
Is there anyone who doesn't? Who on earth? No, no. Who in the whole universe can say they hate donuts?
I do.
You hate donuts? You hate donuts?
No, I'm joking. You can
think
deep fry
about the sensation of biting into a donut.
Sorry, I keep getting paranoid. I keep hearing like music and there's a little slight banging noise in the music, so I'm like, it's making me paranoid. And beer. You can deep fry anything!
First of the sweetness floods in your mouth, and the soft dough.
Oh no!
Next you get the hint of egg and butter, right? Well, that's not what I actually think of when I eat the donut. It's weird.
She
Your
loves
whole
it.
Body starts to melt.
Mm.
Stop it. You feel like you're falling into the center of the donut itself. When people talk about a donut effect, that's what they're talking about. That sounds pretty amazing, though.
That's absolutely not true.
I can't take it anymore. I'm drilling like microphones.
Just a second.
Get out of my way, Makoto, or I got an uppercut with your name on it.
Jesus. Why is she threatening my life just for donuts?
I mean, I would threaten your life if it meant food, too.
I'm upset at you. I'm like, not in the like, way.
Like, if I wanted McDonald's and you didn't, like, provide me with McDonald's, I'm like, I have an uppercut with your name.
Jesus.
Wait for me, God of Donuts.
Almost before she was done talking, Hina took off like a bat out of hell. Whenever I'm around her, I feel like I'm soaking in the essence of human vitality.
Vitality?
Yes, I fixed it. Hina's report card has been updated based on your experience with her. Your maximum number of skill points has increased. Hey, look at you go! And your arm. After I watched her run off, I went back to my room. Alright. I feel even worse than I did this morning. My body feels like lead and now I'm getting chills. This is bad. I think I might be getting sick. Free time! Wait, we're feeling sick, but we're still willing to go out and talk to people. Well, whatever. Okay, but who should we hang out with next?
The dynamic duo.
Well, we only can hang out with one of the two stupid people.
Talk to the smart one.
So, you mean Yasuhiro, right?
Yeah.
So no.
Yeah.
You say the smart one, but I look at the two of them and I question who's the smart one.
Okay, let's talk to Mr. High Horse.
Oh, okay, there you go. That sounds correct. Scurrying around again, huh? Looks like you looking at you makes me physically ill. Should I talk to Byakuya for a while? Spend some time with Byakuya.
Even though he doesn't like you.
Fine. I don't mind allowing you to indulge in my attention. I hope you appreciate this. Jesus Christ. Baby, you're the one that made me. I spent some time with Byakuya. Byakuya and I grew a little closer today. Sure. What would you like to give him?
Tea.
What?
Tea.
Rosehip tea? Herbal tea, said to promote beauty and wellness. No. What does this do? Basic produce to evaporate of seawaters. Yes, perseverance. Nope. Rations, flotation donuts, sunflower seeds. Ooh, kitten hair clip. Everlasting bracelet, love status ring. Many things I would think you would like. Muramasa. Radio with a retro exterior, but state-of-the-art technology inside. Of course, there's no reception in the school, so you can't hear anything anyway. Crystal skull, golden airplane, prince of Shotoku's globe. What? Let's see, spherical representation of Earth, about the size of a softball. Some believe, leave it to be the double O part, since it depicts Earth around, despite being many centuries old. Ashura's tears. I'll give him this again.
I see.
Now this is a rare moment. Coming from a noble family member, I've never seen exposed to such vulgarity. Interesting. I think I'll keep it. See, Byakuya is so pleased with something I gave him makes me happy. Listen, Makoto. I wanted to ask you something. I must save just in case. He says.
I want you to touch my butt.
What did I miss? Internet cut out. Oh, Oh, daylight saving clicked in. Wait.
Yep, sure.
I'm so confused. My clock says 1:04. Like, wait, what time is it to sleep?
It's now 1:04 for me.
1:04? It's 1:04 for me.
There we go. Is it now one? Yeah, it's one. It just went back an hour. Nope.
It's 1:05 for me.
It's 1:05 for me too, Vivi.
Oh, we're in the same time.
Yay, we're connected. Simple and clean as a whale.
Yeah, let's just continue this.
Listen, Makoto, I want to ask you something. What could Byakuya want to talk to me about? I have a bad feeling about this.
He's gonna be like, sure. I want to feel.
What's up? Stop it. You know, only the chosen few, perhaps 1% of us, are able to succeed in life.
So, in other words,
for the other 99, their dreams never come true. Some never even have a dream in the first place. Spending every waking hour toiling to scrap together a meager living, just barely getting by.
What?
I just don't understand. Is there any meaning to a life like that? Why are you asking me? Because you are a part of the 99%, of course.
Oh, no.
That's fucked up. Why do you even feel the need to ask? I knew he was gonna insult me somehow. Up until now, I've never been around anyone like that. So I'm interested. So tell me, how does it feel like to live a life without hope, without potential, or ambition, or dreams? Jesus Christ, he's sticking this knife
how
in my neck.
How do you know, sir, that he is that 1%?
Come on! I don't have ambition or dreams. I never felt that way about my, like, never felt that way about myself.
Damn, that is so dope. It's so rude. It hurt my feelings.
I have feelings, though. Oh, hi, Fire Card Man 8. I mean, sure, maybe I'll never be as rich as you or anything, but do you have to go around saying that to everyone? Can you only be happy by being better than others? Your complaints are as old and tired as a third-rate pop song from any generation. Damn. You are a part of the 99%. How do you feel about that? I'm pretty okay with it.
I'm okay with it.
That is how you find comfort in your tiny, cold little world. Stop saying stuff like that! Sorry, I cannot speak the truth. No matter how much you push and struggle, people like you will never be in the position to change the world. You could all disappear tomorrow and nothing would change. Your existence is of no consequence. Whether that's true or not, it doesn't matter. Even if you live totally normal, unimportant life, you can still find happiness in that. If I can live a life that I'm satisfied with, that's all that matters. If I spent all my time comparing my life to other people's, I'd never be happy. Sure, maybe you can do that. You were guaranteed success from the day you were born, so...
What?
Hold it. From the day I was born, you have no idea. You don't have any clue what you're talking about.
Oh, he's struck nerve.
What?
Those who are chosen from birth have no concept of what that truly means. I've gone to battle and emerged victorious. That is why I am the chosen. What are you talking about? You're spoiled. All of you, running away into a world of self-indulgence. Battle. competition, rivalry, you run away from it all. That is why the 99% walk the path they do.
Such ignorance.
Good God, your absolutely lack of understanding makes me want to weep. After showing a surprising amount of emotion, Byakuya quickly made his exit. What the heck got into him? Shut up. Shut up. He was acting totally normal until I said something about being guaranteed success from the day he was born. I wonder why that set him off. Byakuya's report card has been updated based on your experience with him. You just unlocked the skill, Envious Influence. Give yourself a pat on the back. You earned it. Yay, I got a new ability. I couldn't stop thinking about Byakuya while I went back to my room.
That's
okay. Shut up.
It's canon.
No, stop. I'm getting the chills. I feel kind of dizzy. I can't help it. I need to sleep. Nighttime wasn't for a while, but I felt like my body had reached its limit. As I dropped onto my bed, I felt like I was falling asleep into a bottomless pit. I was unconscious before my head hit the pillow. Well, that's not quite true. I didn't pass out completely. It was more like my consciousness went dim. I weaved back and forth between sleep and wakefulness. Which is all to say... Why is he still wearing his clothes while he has a blanket on? I was restless. At some point, I found myself wandering through a strange dream. And within the dream, a voice echoed across the walls of my mind.
I understand.
That voice. It's so familiar.
I understand.
It's me.
I understand. I should understand everything.
What?
My goal isn't to get out of here.
What?
It's to stay here.
Huh? Huh? What am I trying to say?
Hope. This is all for hope. And that's why I have to stay. I have to stay here.
Okay, something's fucking with me. If it's making, like, an illusion of myself saying I need to stay.
Hey, I know that face.
Dream just now. What?
Stop.
So strange.
Huh? Oh no! Baby, don't use the knife on me!
Sorry.
No!
He denied me of the keenness.
No! Wait, how did they get into his room? Eh? It's Kyoko again!
Kyoko? What
you blocked me off, but now you're going to go.
What did you say?
Wait, Kyoko said something? He never locked the door. God damn it, Makoto's. Lock your door!
I mean, that is true, because he did plop on the bed because he was tired.
Muddle, come on, feel it!
He's an idiot, period.
Every day is peaceful, every day is joyful. Happy days from time, like the time you wake up to the time you go to sleep. Wishing only for those unchanging, unending happy days. Days of boredom, repeating forever and ever. No abnormalities, as far as the eye can see. Life without the tiniest speck of abnormality.
If the world were like that, I'd consider that pretty damn abnormal.
Agree. Alright.
Good morning, everyone! It is now 7 a.m. and nighttime is officially over. Time to rise and shine! Get ready to greet another beautiful day!
It took longer than usual for me to open my eyes. I let out a deep sigh to bring myself up the rest of the way. The chills, the aches, the unfathomable lethargy, they all disappeared in the night. All that was left was me drenched in sweat. It wasn't just because... Stop it. It wasn't because of whether... I mean, whatever bug I'd caught, either. It was also a dream I had. What the hell was that? I mean, was it even really a dream? I was desperate to recall it. I scrambled to grab onto fragments of the dream and reel them up from the depths of my memory.
Didn't he check to see if the knife's still there?
Not yet. He's still more worried about what happened last night than the whole... Because literally, there was a mass killer, then Kyoko appeared, and then that's it. I mean, okay, the dream that says that it wants him to stay in hope...
He still should check to see if the knife's still there.
Or he also should have just took off his normal... Like, he went to bed and then put the blanket on him all with a full set of clothes. God damn it. I came down with a fever and I couldn't quite get to sleep. And I heard a voice I didn't really understand. And then... All of a sudden, I was awake. And there was a strange person standing next to my bed wearing a mask. And they were holding a knife. I want to say I fought them off, but I don't actually remember. I felt like my mind had been detached from my body, burning up with fever. I was somewhere far away watching my body move on its own. And because of that, I don't remember what really happened. But still, I feel like I resisted them desperately, feverishly. After that, things go black again, and the next thing I remember, Kyoko was there. But what would she have been doing in my room? Yes, I would agree with this. Nightmare caused by sleeping undercover is fully dressed. Yes. What a strange dream. No, was it really a dream? How can I possibly find out either way? Looking for that fucking knife? I open the desk drawer and... Huh? It's empty. There's nothing inside. Wait, nothing inside? That's strange. Because it definitely wasn't before. I'm positive I put the knife I got from Toko in there. Wait, that means... The knife they took, like, told me to keep safe? I knew it. I just had a feeling. It wasn't a dream after all. But if that's true, this all makes even less sense. Why did someone wanted to attack me? And
because
what was it behind the mask?
You're the ultimate main character.
Shush. And why was Kyoko? What the hell's going on? Well, I don't think I'm gonna figure out on my own. I should head to the dining hall. Then I can talk to everyone else about it. Alright, let's leave. Well, Kyoko's still missing. We just saw her. But... Okay, I'm not gonna lie. This is the second time she snuck into our room. Which is weird.
She want the booty.
No! Give me that booty. Wait, where's everyone?
Makoto! Yep, that's Makoto. Sure, as the sky is blue.
Hey, Hina. Wait, why is she acting weird?
What's going on? You really had me worried, you know. What happened to you last night? What happened to you last night?
Did we fuck? You can't answer that. Worried?
Yeah, right after nighttime hit, we all went to get you. What? We were hammering away at your doorbell and you never answered. What?
What?
We thought maybe you didn't, you know. I mean, not that that actually happened. I mean, no one here would have, you know.
I have two people in mind that could do it, though.
So, anyways, what were you doing?
Masturbating.
Yep.
Yeah. I didn't feel good, so I went right to bed. I had no idea you guys even showed up. So, why did you come get me? Did something happen?
Well, lots of stuff, actually. I'm not sure I can really explain.
Okay.
Let's go meet everyone else. Then we can tell you about it.
Damn it, Pip. So, is everyone waiting somewhere else or something?
That's right.
Oh yeah, we all stayed up the whole night and no one bothered to barge into his room.
Well, someone did. Well, technically two people barged into his room.
Yeah, but no one else.
Well, yeah, but I think it's because they have some way to get into his room.
I lost paper, scissors, rock, so I had to come get breakfast for everyone. Oh.
She's a fool. It should have been Yasuhiro that lost.
It's So you got here just in time. Come on, help me carry it.
I mean, not given much of a choice, I guess. Sure. Okay, sure.
Everyone's in the gym. Hurry up and I'll meet you there.
Wait, the gym? Why is everyone in the gym? And the entire night? What? I don't understand. Why was everyone in the gym? Something sounds off to this situation, though.
These do seem like they're in serious pain.
No, it seems like it's gonna be related to that mass killer person.
Most likely. Someone probably, like, almost got murdered, too, as well.
I don't think it's almost. Someone was murdered. You about to die. No! I mean, I understand it's a...
There he is.
Huh? Oh, hey, Makoto.
This is the worst than being late for your wedding, the birth of your son, and your own funeral
yes,
all at
we
once.
Yes, we get it.
What?
Jeez, to show up now, like it's no big deal.
You made us stay up all night while you slept like a baby in your bed.
What?
What?
Just like Hina said, everyone was there besides Kyoko. Then I notice they formed a circle around something. As soon as I saw that something was... What the? Before I caught myself, I cried out. Wait, what? Sprout out in front of them were the remains of Monokuma. Wait, someone broke a Monokuma without causing it to explode?
What are you doing?
What does it look like? We're dismantling it to see what makes it tick.
What the hell?
Dismantling? But
I mean, like how she's holding
that's
up.
That's Monokuma you're messing with, right?
Yeah, that's right.
She's not even fazed.
Why isn't anyone, like, worried about the whole it has a bomb? Relax. There's no danger. You say that, but... What is this? What are you guys doing? Seriously! It looks like it's been professionally disassembled. How's that possible? Tearing apart something like that isn't dangerous?
Yagiya, explain. I don't want to hear from Yasuhiro. Seriously, what are you thinking?
Why was Yasuhiro the one that was dismantling it?
Don't worry about it. Listen, don't worry about it.
How can you, like, say tearing apart something like that isn't dangerous? What? Idiot. If you hadn't been sleeping in, you'd already know what's going on.
Hey, come on.
Well, I guess I'll handle this. I'll explain what's going on, Makoto, because that's how much I like you. Yakio found this little fellow laying around, and then we tore it apart.
He's a pro.
That doesn't explain anything!
What?
Just before we went to bed last night, I came to the gym and tried to talk to Monokuma. I wanted to see if he had any new information about Kyoko's disappearance. And I found him here, just like normal. However, we found him. He was no more than a regular toy. He didn't react, he didn't say a word. You're saying he wasn't moving at all? I waited there until nighttime officially began, but still Monokuma lay there motionless. I gathered everyone up as quickly as possible so they could take a look. Even then, he still didn't make a move. So I immediately initiated the disassembly process.
It was Master
Stroke.
A chance to find out what made Monokuma tick.
One thing we discovered is that he's quite a sophisticated machine. It's leagued beyond any normal remote control toy. Who has enough free time to invest in something like that anyway? But besides that, I'm wondering is why did he stop moving all of a sudden? I thought maybe he malfunctioned. But we didn't find any cause as we were taking him apart. So if he didn't break down,
in other words,
then maybe something happened to his puppeteer. the mastermind something unexpected. I can't imagine any other possibility. Something unexpected?
They were probably so scared of me, Master. They ran away to Earth.
Could God.
Or good. Maybe they got sick or something.
What?
But Monokuma made his announcement this morning, right? Who was that if it's not the mastermind? I'm sure that's a recording. It's set to a timer and plays as necessary.
That's true. He said the exact same thing every day, right?
Hey.
Hey guys, I don't think now is a good time for like conversation. I just found something. What's this? It's
bomb.
It's what? A bomb. There's one installed in every Monokuma robot, I'm sure.
What? A bomb!
Really?
Yes.
That's super bad. We need to get rid of it. Like, how did he not get it was a bomb?
Because Yasuhiro is an idiot and he just noticed and he picked it up out of the robot.
Even then, why did they let Yasuhiro?
Because Byaki is a dickhead, okay? Listen. He wants to kill Yasuhiro without necessarily killing him. Roger that. It appears the bomb... Ah, shit. And here's the worst thing that's gonna happen. It appears the bomb has a motion sensor. Any sudden movements, it's sure to go off. Motion sensor? For serious? Ugh, I'm starting to get all shaky.
Just a second.
Hey, get it together. You're a man, aren't you?
Fuck you.
Aren't you really?
Fine, I'm totally fine.
You're not so fine, yo.
Oh, I probably should have mentioned the motion sensor is off right now. Fuck you, Byakuya.
Jeez, don't scare me like that.
No, it's like you're the world's most spineless worm of the century.
Fuck you, I'd be scared too. Don't be mean.
Hey, come on, the century's just getting started. Don't call the race already.
Whatever. Just hurry up with the bomb down. Oh, hurry up with the bomb down. Hanging on to it's not gonna do anyone good.
I think it would be smarter to like put it somewhere where if it explodes, it would be safer. It would be smart to put.
Oh yeah, good call.
Well?
Okay, it's down. Everything's all good. Hiro put the bomb down, but that wasn't my main concern at this point. My eyes were glued to Monokuma's remains. He just stopped moving all of a sudden. Was it really because something had happened to the mastermind that they weren't expecting? But what could have happened? What could that have been? When I thought about it, I couldn't help but think back to the night before, being attacked by the masked figure.
Just a second!
Hey, Makoto?
Huh?
Hey!
Don't haunt us! Did you hear a thing we just said? Huh?
So that's a no. What are you, some kind of brain-dead farm animal?
Coming from you, little pup.
Hey.
Sorry. No, I don't mean you, you love. I meant Toko. She a pup.
We're saying, since we're done dismantling Monokuma, what should we do now?
And we've decided to continue our offensive assault.
It's all clear now.
To try to uncover the mastermind's true identity, we're going to break into the headmaster's room. Really?
Naturally.
Wait, what?
Like, well, someone's already beating me to the punch.
Well, they don't know it. And if Makoto says anything, they'll all, you know, not trust Makoto. That's the thing.
Since the mastermind appears to have stopped all activity, now's our chance, wouldn't you agree? But if the mastermind comes back while we're in there?
What?
If you're scared, you're welcome to stay here by yourself.
What the heck?
Or go live in the chicken coop. with all the other chickens, you can be chicken number 6.
Oh, good boy.
Shots fired.
Such ignorance.
This is a battle, a fight to the death between us and the mastermind. We don't have time to deliberate.
Yeah, I mean, I don't wanna have to kill each other or anyone else, but we have a chance now.
Come on.
So, what are you going to do? Are you going to run away, or are you going to fight? All right, I'll go.
It's all clear now.
Okay then, we're going to break into the headmaster's room. Everything comes down to this moment. Anything can happen, so prepare yourself.
I'll follow you anywhere, Master. Tall hands of the earth.
Yes, you would. She's such a bitch in heat.
Sakura, if you can hear me, lend me your strength.
And then Aoi just ends up becoming super buff and her hair grows out and her boobs like shrivel up into the like...
Oh.
Like, dish, dish, dish. I'm here with Ohina. Or, I've used my power with your body. Use it wisely.
How about that?
I can do this. I'm a man. I can do this. I've got the will of the entire universe on my side. We found determination in our own ways. And when we were ready, we left the gym. Our target was the headmaster's room. Why don't we go to the data room? Wouldn't it make sense?
The biolab.
Yeah, fuck the biolab. I'm a little bit more concerned about the whole information room that has something relevant. I understand the bio room, yes.
I'm like, because I know in the bio room it's going to lead to what happened to that one room.
Well, for now, let's see what happens. Alright, well, I still question why don't we try to, you know, I'm going to try to go to the data room. Rattle, rattle. The door won't budge. It must be locked. Are you serious? We could still try. No? Okay. I hate everyone. Ah, Aoi. You scared me. Bye.
Aoi.
Alright, rattle, rattle.
It's locked as expected. So, what do you... Wait, yeah, no, that makes no sense. Sucker broke the door.
Open.
So, what are you gonna do?
What?
Isn't it obvious? We're going to tear this door off its hinges.
Wait, what? The rules say...
We've seen the mastermind isn't watching us. Those don't matter anymore.
But
like Makoto said, if the mastermind did show up while we were in there...
So in other words...
Then we'll just have to finish our business before that happened.
Hey!
Okay, sure, but...
What?
We've come this far. We can't back down now. We agreed this is what we have to do. So we have to do this.
So beautiful.
I mean...
We're serious?
What the heck? We don't have any choice. We're desperate. God, sometimes Toko makes me cringe. Let's do it. Let's rip this door down. Like, this is the way Toko is with him. No.
It's beautiful. Okay, but...
No, it's just certain things.
You say certain things, but there's everything that she says that kind of makes me like,
Okay, but... How are we gonna do that? This thing looks pretty sturdy. Then we'll need something sturdier of our own. Oh. What about that one thing? The thing in the tool shed.
Oh, so then.
Oh yeah, the pickaxe.
Like I said, Kyoko is the murderer.
No, Shining Darkness, don't say that.
Kyoko the waifu.
I see.
Interesting. That would be would be exactly what we need. Now then, Toko, what time is it?
Well, we left the gym, so it's just before 9 o'clock, but probably 9 on the dot now.
It's all clear now.
Okay, go get the axe and be here by 9:01.
What
the fuck? That's straight up unreasonable.
I myself?
Naturally.
Sure.
She's gonna die.
You like to have your me time once in a while, right?
Well, if it's me and you time, Master, then yeah. God.
Yeah, I agree to that, Blank. You and me time. Wink.
What?
Yeah.
So I married her. Anyways. You know how much time it took for you to say that? 10 seconds. Take too long and I'll erase your existence from my consciousness.
Yuck! Unacceptable!
With that, Toko ran off, loud as a herd of rabid elephants.
Hey.
We're serious, though. Are we gonna knock this door down? So, wait, but the door is unlocked. I mean, someone broke the lock, if I remember correctly. No problem is solved
by
running away.
She said Sakura broke it.
Exactly. So I don't understand. Find your stones and be a man. He's right.
Yeah,
you can't move forward by always avoiding danger.
If you spend all your time trying to avoid danger,
you'll never move forward.
She?
Yeah. Okay, then that part's like flashback. I mean, no voice, so it's like.
We know the danger, but if it's the risk that means solving the mystery, we have no choice.
Yes, Lord Vader.
Hey.
What? I was like yawning in the middle of talking. Am I wrong?
What?
Yes.
Even if it's dangerous, we have to overcome the challenge in front of us.
Maybe, yeah,
but I'm still super stressed. I'm so tense, I can hardly talk. I'm so flubus, no. Totally flabag, flabstef.
What?
Dennis, I chills.
What?
Did she just say fapsauce? Gross. Where'd that come from? Wait, Genocide Jill, where'd you come from?
You called for me, and so I appear.
Hello, hello. It's God.
It's the mixture of wonderful with furious.
It's the wonderful. Oh, the one for. That word. Where the furious fiend. Here to get rid of you with a razor sharp smile.
That's a tongue.
Sorry, my tongue got me.
Come on.
What about the pickaxe? Where is it?
I was supposed to pick an axe?
No, you seeping imbecile, the pickaxe.
Seeping imbecile? Oh, Master, you wound me with your... with your executive level... Oh, God. Bushwa?
Yes.
Is that what it is?
Yes. It's just bushwa.
You have a bloody nose. Seriously, though, did you really forget the pickaxe?
Give it a rest. Really? Omega-3 fatty acids. That's what you need. Great for the old memory factory. I think we already established that their memory doesn't carry over when they switch.
Not possible.
This is a level of uselessness I find difficult to tolerate.
Yes.
The light bulb just went on.
I see.
That's why I went to the garden, right? I was supposed to get the pickaxe. I totally like choked on it when I was trying to talk. Alright, solved one mystery. That means there's just one more mystery left.
One more mystery?
Mm-hmm. Have you reached that certain age?
Now we just need to figure out the identity of the object F.
So,
now, what are you talking about?
Did you already forget what we were talking about? You're like missing out on life.
You gotta be kidding!
I'm not missing out on life. In fact, I found one in the garden. No.
What? What did you find?
Cool, post. What?
You SOB!
Different ones.
A corpse?
No.
No.
I said corpse.
A corpse?
Yep.
That's right. I found a corpse in the garden.
You found a corpse in the garden?
Oh.
What did you say?
Then, before we enter the headmaster's room, it appears we have something else to look into.
Come on.
We're going to the garden. Okay.
No.
No.
If it's Kyoko, I'm seriously gonna cry. I don't even care if we're streaming.
Oh, wow. So, like, whenever I cry about Sakura, you're like, you cry, you weird boyfriend.
Sakura's weird.
Fuck you! She was amazing! She could take on Monokuma! Did you not see that clash of a kick? That was badass!
She could
flex.
Everyone loves Kyoko.
But I love Sakura.
But Kyoko was more helpful and useful.
But Sakura was the muscle. She was there to defend us. She sacrificed us. She did a Jesus.
But, you can't deny it's going to be a bit sad and a bit hard now that, Yoko's dead. Because, she did have the resources and she did have a way around things.
You know what was sad? Having Chihiro die.
Aww.
Kyoko doesn't even live, says Shining Darkness. God damn it. As soon as we entered the garden, I saw it. I didn't want to, but the knife. I saw someone laying on the ground with a mask covering their face. And there was a knife buried in their stomach up to the hilt. What the? Are they really dead? For sure, but who is it? Chapter 5, 100 Mile Dash, Pain of the Junk Food Junkie, Deadly Life. Just to make things clear, last night I was attacked by someone wearing a mask, and whoever it was, now they're... I don't know why, but now they're laying dead in front of me.
I told you there was a curse hanging out here. Really?
No way!
Oh! Actually, that makes sense now. Why?
Are they really? What?
Oh, sorry. Go ahead. Finish.
Are they really dead? Is this really a dead body?
Okay, so the thing I was saying was why Genocide Jill popped in was because Telko saw the dead body and she was triggered to Genocide Jill.
What?
You need to begin looking around right away, however. Be ever so careful. There's no telling what you might find. First things first, I want to check the shed. I have to check the body before anything else. No! It is Kyoko. You know how I know?
The shoes.
We need to find out who this actually is. There's no way to tell with the mask covering their face like that. And the white coat they're wearing makes it impossible to tell anything about the body itself. The victim is a total mystery, but one thing I do know is that whoever this is, they attacked me last night in my room. But why? And how did they, wind up dead in here? Their heart isn't beating. They're not breathing. All signs of life have come to a complete stop. Thanks to the knife that's been driven in their stomach. Their clothes are stained a bright red. It appears the bleeding has stopped, but blood that's there is still wet. Be careful not to touch it and get some on you.
How can you be so calm at a time like this? Who is it? Their face and body are all hidden, so I don't have a clue.
I'm pretty sure it's a girl at least.
Huh? How can you tell?
Well, I think I see the outline of her chest and the general shape of the body. Yeah, the more I look at it, I'm sure it's a girl.
Really? Then could it be?
God, her laugh is so weird.
Okay then. Let's just tear off the mask clean off.
No, Genocide Jill, don't! Wait, don't! By the time it came, he called out, it was already too late. Koko's hand shot towards the mask. And that next instant... What?! What?!
It was a bomb.
There was a bomb in a body? There was a blinding light and a deafening roar, and Toko was knocked the fuck back! The body
Dude,
blew
literally,
up.
Look how tall she was. Look how far she got in the air.
It blew up, 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 it blew up! My vision started to darken. I prepared to pass out, but then...
Come on.
Hurry up and put out the fire. As my consciousness attempted to float away, the voice reached up and pulled it back down to Earth. Someone pressed something into my hands. It was a bucket of water.
Come on, dump the water on it.
Okay. Upon half of the body was on fire, I took aim and tossed water as hard as I could. Sploosh. Thankfully, it was enough to put out the fire. It died down, leaving the body only the unpleasant smell of burning. I guess that took care of it. But what the hell, man?
Huh? It exploded.
What did you say?
I had a bad feeling about that body. But I never imagined it would explode. Wait, what'd you say, Bob?
I said, and Joe got knocked the fuck back.
Shaking my head.
No one's gonna check on Toko.
No. No. No one gives a fuck that much, baby.
No, we're just gonna move on up here.
Yeah. And now the body.
What?
It's burned to a crisp. That's beyond well done. I mean, well done, man.
Don't compare it to a steak. I'll never be able to eat a steak again.
Oh, you'll still be able to eat meat. Wink.
You're dumb.
I'm glad you noticed. Now that the body's charred, I really have no idea. How are we gonna find out who it was? Who isn't here right now? Huh? If we consider who's not here, that will quickly narrow down who it must be.
There's only one person missing. Well, there's two people missing. The mastermind and Kyoko.
Actually, wait! You mean three people?
That was the 16th student?
Exactly. I think this person right in front of us is the 16th person. It's Kyoko. Kyoko! Then that dead body is Kyoko? No. That can't be right. Calm down. I didn't say it was Kyoko.
But,
I mean, who else? There is one other person.
Another word.
The mastermind.
What?
The mastermind?
What the heck?
Come on, there's no way the mastermind got charbroiled. Get serious! I agree. The idea wouldn't be worth considering. But I have reason to believe it may be true. The mastermind being dead would explain the other matter, wouldn't it? Monokuma would hardly move around if its master is dead, right? But that corpse is a girl, right? It doesn't make any sense. I mean, remember what Alter Ego said?
Get a height measurement. You have everyone else's measurements.
I mean...
Oh yeah, the report cards.
I mean, remember what Alter Ego said?
So, the same person may very well be the mastermind who planned all this out. And according to the files, the headmaster is a man in his late 30s. It seems possible, even likely, that he's somewhere in this school right now.
What the heck?
You like my impression of Chihiro? Babu?
Sure.
Wow, fuck you too.
He said the mastermind is some middle-aged dude, right? Which the corpse obviously isn't.
Then, could that mean the mastermind isn't the headmaster? Is it the teenage girl Kyoko told me about? The ultimate despair?
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah.
Mukuro Ikusaba, the 16th student at Hope's Peak!
What?
What are you talking about? The other day, Kyoko confided in me. She said there was a 16th student here in the school.
What?
I think you better tell us everything you know.
Well, all Kyoko told me was...
Mukuro Ikusaba.
They keep using this scene over and over, and they have the same voices.
The 16th student.
Yeah. Well, it's still cool, and it helps for a flashback.
The ultimate despair. Watch out for her.
It sounded like Kyoko thinks Mukuro Ikusaba is the mastermind.
So she's like, no, the mastermind isn't. Yes, Hail Hydra. Hail Hydra, baby.
Oh. Chicken. Wait,
it's
not speaking?
What? No, she isn't speaking in this part.
No, the headmaster isn't the mastermind, I'm sure of that.
That. What?
I don't have proof yet, but I have no doubt I might.
Right. Left.
I see.
Left?
Because I'm right, left.
There's another student here. Is that a female? That would match the Bonnie's characteristics.
And that phrase, the ultimate despair, that sounds super mastermindy, doesn't it? Mastermindy.
Listen, she's an airhead. Leave her alone. She's innocent.
Okay, so the mastermind is this girl, Mukuro? And she's a student here and she's the ultimate despair? But if she's like... If she's been hiding here in the school like some teenage Bigfoot, how'd she wind up burnt to a crisp?
What the heck?
None of this makes any sense! To just suddenly show up and then die?
I think we'd better take a closer look at the body. There may be some clues to help us figure out exactly who it is.
Hey, wait!
What?
What?
Thank you. Aren't we forgetting something? No.
Yeah, she kind of took the explosion point blank.
What?
Oh yeah. She got totally burnt up, huh? Blown
up.
Forget about her. I'm sure the explosion vaporized her.
Oh, she survived.
How? How in God's name did she survive?
I don't know how she survived.
Oh, she survived. Jesus.
What just happened, Master?
Stop talking.
You declared the whole world to hear that you would never again inhale a single molecule of oxygen. Of oxygen.
Then, I don't mind breathing in the carbon dioxide. That's enough for me to live.
Jesus Christ.
What the heck?
This is the strangest back and forth I've ever seen.
Very.
Alright, well, let's figure out some few things. Right now I have to focus on the body. But what about the mask? Whenever she removed it, it triggered the explosion. I should take a close look at the body one more time.
So, watch yourself, Makoto. She may be dead, but she's still a girl. So?
I'm gonna touch her boobies. Her charted boobies. Don't worry, I don't plan on touching the body all that much. I'm not Kyoko after all.
Look at those nail polish on her hands.
Hold on, there's something on the ground there. So we're not gonna figure out the whole symbol on her hand. There's something to the body.
Oh.
It's a key. I mean, it's a key? Is it what Kyoko took from Monokuma? But what did you steal? Steal, take.
I stole this.
Is that a key? Key? Kingdom Hearts?
We're so dummy.
yes, no. But looking at it, I could tell it wasn't any key. It was shaped like Monokuma. Probably the only key of its kind on Earth. Uranus. That's right, the key she stole was shaped like Monokuma. This isn't anything like that. Then this key is...
What?
We're not gonna acknowledge the symbol on her hand?
Nope, apparently not. What did you find? I mean, did you find something?
Body?
Wait, what?
Can you go back to the body?
No, Byaki is interrupting like a dickhead. Yeah, this was on the ground near the body. I've never seen this key before. What could it possibly go to? So, even you don't know then? Makoto, I'm gonna give you a very important task. Huh?
I see.
That key might give you access to certain areas we thought were locked. You mean...
So in other words...
The biolab, the data center, the headmaster's room, and the dorm rooms on the second floor. It's in your hands. So, I'm your errand boy now? Wait.
Oh.
But what about the design on the hand? What about the dead body? Why didn't we examine her hair? I give up. Being the errand boy for everyone fucking sucks.
Is that the biolab you want to?
Yeah, I'm heading to the biolab first since it's the closest. We're gonna see if it's possible to open it up using that. The biolab was definitely locked before. Okay, let's give it a shot. When I insert the key I found in the garden, into the keyhole, the key isn't even close to fitting. Which means the key doesn't go to this room. I don't think it's even a key. I think it's a USB, in my opinion. And it's either a USB, or the second best thing, a key to the data room. I'm gonna try the data room first before I try to check the headmaster's room. Headmaster's room is supposed to be unlocked because Kyoko broke through. The door to the data center room was definitely locked before. Okay, let's give it a shot. I went to insert the key and found in the garden's keyhole. Click. Yes, I thought so. It was. It fits. Then this key is the key to the data center. I managed to unlock the data center. I guess I'll run around, I guess all that running around paid off. I have to tell everyone else. I immediately headed back to the garden. But what about the... I give up. So, how'd it go? I found out which room the key goes to. It's the data center on the fourth floor. Then we can get into the data center now?
I see.
Interesting. But why did the now deceased have the key from them?
I suppose we have to go. I mean, go to the data center and find out. Yeah, I think you're right. Oh no. Here we are. Looks like the door is still unlocked.
Hey, so when you open that door, there's not gonna be another huge kaboom like before, right?
You're asking that question now? Don't worry, we have Makoto. What the hell?
Jesus.
Why is he making me the scapegoat? What?
In other words,
it's in your hands. Oh shit. What? Again? I mean, I trust you, Snicker. That's an absolute lie. I'm just being used. Wait, I'm gonna check on Toko real quick. She literally took an explosion point blank.
Master told you he trusts you, right? Master told you that?
What the heck?
Well, don't let it go to your head.
I am so not happy about any of this. I'm the one being forced into this situation. This sucks. I reach out and put my hand on the door.
Boom.
Let the player character do it. They'll be fine. I close my eyes and try to clear my mind. With a silent prayer, I slowly open the door. Alright, we're gonna finally see what's behind here. Dots. Nothing happened. After making sure I was still alive, I slowly opened my eyes. Whoa! In a word, the room was strange. I mean, all the rooms till now were strange, but still, this room had a special kind of strangeness.
It has a Monokuma door.
Yes, but the thing I'm worried about is the whole that you could see everyone's rooms in this room. So this was the main room. Till now was strange, but this room had a special kind of strangeness. It wasn't a surface fear like the rest of the school. Here, the fear was lurking beneath the surface. This room was filled with that kind of dread.
What?
Hey, that's... Hiro extended a trembling hand and pointed. Look at all those monitors on the wall. Look what they're showing. Each monitor displayed a different section of the school. The dorms, the classrooms, every part of the school was covered. I mean, could we... This is...
What?
It's a direct feed from every single surveillance camera. All cameras in the room... And all the cameras in the room feed back to this room. And all displayed here on these monitors.
So that's it.
So the sole purpose of this room is to watch us. To watch us!
Then this room is...
It's all clear now.
The mastermind's private room, without a doubt.
I feel like he's freaking out because he's probably mastered it in his room.
Yes. I mean, I'd still be creeped out, seriously. Wait, one of the cameras showing something weird. Out of all of these, there's one that I kind of think is different from the rest. I think I see the headmaster's room from one of the cameras. The mastermind's room. I guess that makes sense. So the mastermind was here. Watching us. Then I think this settles it. Hi, Bubba.
What?
Nothing. The body in the garden. If they had the key to the room, it can only mean one thing. That was the body of Mukuro Ikusaba, and she was the mastermind. No.
And the mastermind is dead? Like, really, really dead?
I doubt that, though. That's the thing. It would
it's
seem
too
so.
Too fishy.
Yeah. For serious?
It's too bad they had to go and die before the master could kill him. Jesus, will you stop?
Baby, this is you. That's you.
I know, that's why I'm telling her to stop. It sounds like things I would say.
The mastermind is dead? Could that really be true? Does that mean it's all over? Because...
what do you think if the mastermind is not wrong?
I feel like there's still something off. Because, I mean, that body... whatever happened, they obviously didn't die a natural death. So, who was that?
But
if the mastermind really is dead, that means we can finally get out of this hellhole!
How about that?
We gotta hurry up and find an exit, come on!
That's enough.
No, we have to check the area thoroughly first.
Huh?
But what about the exit? If the mastermind is truly dead, we can leave whenever we decide to. But right now, we need to find out why the mastermind set up this life or death game in the first place. And I'm bothered by the fact that the mastermind was obviously murdered.
Murdered?
So you think so too,
naturally.
Huh?
Naturally.
The state of the corpse made it plain as day. There is absolutely no doubt. The mastermind was murdered.
But...
why is this gotta be that way? I mean, who could have, even done it?
Such ignorance.
That's exactly why we need to investigate the purpose and identity of the mastermind.
I'm telling you!
Now do you understand, you useless insect? You're all banned from talking to Master Everett.
The mastermind's purpose and why they were killed. This room may very well hold the answers to those questions. After all, the mastermind must have spent who knows how long to... how much time here. Okay, then let's begin. Wait. Go ahead.
If Kyoko isn't dead, that means, his whole part where he sees Kyoko would be true, and she did kill the murderer that was trying to kill him.
Or it's the opposite way around, because the thing that I just remembered was Kyoko has this one little detail. She always wears gloves.
That's true.
So it might be Kyoko, and that's the thing I'm worried about. So let us begin our search. It's time to uncover the true identity of the mastermind. Alright, let me see. Alright, there's a ridiculous number of monitors here. The mastermind's using them to spy on, use them all to spy on us.
As long as I have this.
Huh?
Look at Master go. It's like a feast for the eyes. How much is my monthly?
Gosh. Finish. Commit.
I am, but you left at the end.
I cut you off, but still. Dots. God damn it, Toko. Why do you have to ruin this moment? This is important. Look at some things real quick. There's nothing to show up on this one. Hey, look, next to that TV. Isn't that a TV antenna?
How about that?
It is. It's just like the one my grandma uses. It's totally one of those high def antennas. Wait, so if we hook up that antenna, we could watch TV?
Huh? Did someone say TV?
You know?
Well, Saturday morning Hina's here.
Are you talking about me?
Okay.
Anyways, if we can watch TV, let's do it. Come on.
You know?
Huh, you're all starved for info from the outside world, huh? Alright, let me work my magic and you'll be a quantum leaping your way to TV land before you know it. I'm so upset because I actually got that joke. I mean, I get the reference, but what's he talking about?
Do you get the reference, baby?
No.
What?
I might know the reference. I might not. I'm like.
What is it?
My brain's dead right now.
Yeah. It was an old TV show. It was actually pretty good too. Okay, so there's a TV antenna. There's a bunch of computers all lined up. They all look high-performance PCs. Nothing like ancient laptop. I mean, like the ancient laptop Alter Ego was installed on.
Hmm.
They're all on. They all seem to be locked.
Hmm. So what? We can't do anything? Just use your fighting spirit to force your way in.
No.
That's how it works.
Damn it, if we had Chihiro here, though. She was the ultimate programmer.
Huh? What century are you from?
The stupid kind. Anyways, the mastermind would have been using these monitors, to monitor the network and Alter Ego. Hmm. You may well be right about
what?
That. But there's no point in thinking about it now. You're right. Well, all that's left is to talk to everyone.
Jeez, I can't believe how many monitors there are. My eyes are flickering as fast as they are.
Alright, it's Byakuya. Why was the mastermind murdered? To figure that out, we need to find out the identity and purpose of the mastermind.
The door?
No, not yet. I want to talk to everyone. You got to make sure to talk to everyone. It's important. So, you think you can fix that,
the
TV? Just a little longer. What do you really want to watch TV that bad? Another Saturday morning kid here. God damn it. I get it now. Say it.
The master's going through all this stuff. It's like an all-you-watch buffet.
Dots. Okay, now we can go into this stupid room. This door's kind of creepy. It's got a picture of Monokuma on it. Baby, would you want a door that has Monokuma all over it?
Hell yes, I would.
God damn it. What could be inside? Rattle, rattle. No luck.
The door is locked, huh? What if you use that key to open this room?
Let's give it a try, just in case. Rattle, rattle. Nope, it's no good. It won't even fit in the key. Oh my god, I just figured out that Monokuma key. Kyoko has the key for this room.
Oh shit, yeah, she does.
That makes sense. But the question is, where's that key then? And where is she? She appeared before us. Anyways, yeah, go ahead.
Well, don't worry about it. Everything's fine. Wouldn't they have to go back to the ship to get the pickaxe to open the headmaster's door?
We could, but for now we're still stuck here. It won't let us go back anyways.
Oh, the headmaster is dead, right? So nothing's gonna happen to us.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Can't stop thinking about the door with Monokuma's picture on it. But worrying about it isn't gonna do me any good. Hina's right, you're Brett. Anyways, Hina's right. The mastermind's gone, so there's nothing to be afraid anymore.
You know?
Oh. What's wrong? Good news for you all Sunday morning kitties out there. I think I got the TV working.
Really?
Now all we gotta do is switch it on.
What?
Then do it. Freaking idiot mastermind. Oh, you guys need to cut free from your regrets of the outside world.
What the heck?
And they're sitting here watching TV the whole time. They really thought they could get away with it. Huh? What?
Huh?
It's an antenna. For that camera that's monitoring them. This is...
It's the feed coming from the surveillance camera monitoring this room, isn't it?
What the heck?
Huh.
Huh, that's weird.
Come on.
Hey, what are you doing?
That's really weird.
You're weird. Weird in every possible way. And not just weird, super weird.
Shut up. But this TV isn't hooked up to anything but the antenna. So, how is it showing the camera feed?
Well,
you try changing the channel?
Oh, good idea. Let's give it a try.
Hero went through each channel one by one. But on every channel was just us. It was just a live feed of us standing there in the data center.
What the heck?
What the heck?
Is it broken or something?
Could it be?
No, there must be some kind of trick to it. Some weird setup.
A trick? What kind of-
Oh my god.
No!
Actually,
I'm not sure, but-
What?
What?
It's been a while, you frickin' bastards!
Monokuma!
How? You're just dead. God, that means Kyoko is.
Me? Dead? Don't be frickin' stupid!
What? Hey, you're acting all kind of strange. Something seems different.
Of course!
Of course, I'm different. Evolution is pretty natural. After all, I've been hibernating for 2 years already.
Not even. It's been half a day at most.
How are you alive again?
Oh yeah, that's it. The looks on your face right now is sublime. That's what I want to see the moment you went from hope to despair.
Don't tell me you were pretending to be dead all. I mean, all for this moment.
Why would a bear pretend to be dead? You're the ones who pretend to be dead when you see a bear. I mean, that's totally laughable. It makes me laugh. I'm gonna laugh right now.
I'm having too much fun with Monokuma, so.
And that's that. Well then, it's almost time to cut off your past so full of hope. And begin this despair at the future ahead of you. I want you all to have way more fun in this killing game.
Huh? You can't be serious. We have to keep going?
Let me out of here!
No, we're supposed to get out of here!
Get out of here? You're still obsessed with getting out of here.
Unbelievable.
How do you not get it? There is no getting out of here. And besides,
yep.
Life isn't all bad, you know? I mean, there's stuff you wouldn't like about life no matter where you are.
Are you serious? This place is the worst.
If it's the worst, does that mean you're in despair? Well, I'm pooped from all of that laughing. I guess I'll just get to the point now.
The point?
Hey,
you guys really, struck gold when you found that TV. Yes, indeed, that TV is an essential part of your school life here.
What?
I knew it was hiding a secret of some kind.
What the heck?
But I connected an antenna, so why is it just showing us? I mean, us the surveillance feed.
Look how attentive they are now. Well then, I'm going to tell you in on the blood-gushing secret and tell you about it. That TV is absolutely without a doubt displaying signal coming in on the antenna.
Huh? What does that mean?
What the heck?
It's displaying the signal, but it's just us standing here.
Unbelievable.
You're so stupid. Don't you get it? Fine, I'll just tell you.
Thrills, chills, kills!
This game is being broadcasted live to the entire world. It's the most popular thing on TV.
What?
Extreme!
This killing game is being broadcasted live to the entire world! It's the most popular thing on TV!
It doesn't matter how many times he says it. I don't know what's supposed to, what's it supposed to mean? I mean, if I understood the words, I'm not sure I'd understand the deeper meaning.
I mean, that does explain all those, like, deaths in that room.
Yeah.
What? Broadcast live to the entire world? What kind of bad joke is this?
The worst kind.
Oh, I see the little pachinko machine room where you can get all the stuff using the Monokuma coins. That's cool. I like that detail. Anyways.
That's... It can't be. Have they taken over the airwaves somehow? The camera feed is being broadcast? No way, that's impossible!
That kind of overconfidence is a major weakness in your crisis management system. You know that? You know that? All you need is one weird trick in that, like, that I found. And hijacking the airwaves is easy mode.
Are you being serious right now?
Of course!
Of course!
I heard of creaking. But the sound was coming from my own mind. Like a boat tossing in the ocean, my mind had begun to creak and groan.
Hey, everything has a meaning, you know? All those hints I gave you, all those tantalizing tidbits about the school's mysteries. Even me luring you here right now. Why would I do any...
Oh, excuse me, everyone. Anyways.
Why would I do any of that without a reason? It was all for my captive audience to show them the true despair like they've never seen before. I became the director of a despair-based production. This is the ultimate reality show, the best in despair entertainment.
What are you saying?
You're lying. If this was on TV, everyone else would be going crazy.
Yeah, there's no way they wouldn't have tried to come and rescue us.
Actually,
what if they already did?
Huh?
Yes, indeed.
But then again, it's not really any of their business, right? Sure, some people might yell at their TV and try to warn you, but who would actually come here to help? Don't you think that's possible? I don't really know personally, though, so whatever.
This can't be.
But to take control of all communications like that, you'd need an astronomical amount of sources.
Yep. So how long things come this far? Well, that's a secret. There's something you all need to know first.
What?
Of course.
Well, duh. There's the little business of ding ding.
A body has been discovered. After a certain amount of time, which you may use however you like, the class trial will begin.
And so, we're back into this situation again. Huh?
Class trial? Do you mean...
I'm sorry.
You know, when you do the long laughs, I feel like you're like pointing at each of the cues while you're laughing.
I'm just having fun.
It's the Monokuma file!
I'll leave the next moment, Monokuma file right here, everyone. Give it all you got, okay?
Heart-pounding excitement!
Okay, things are gonna get pretty crazy from here on, huh? You're in for a heck of a ride.
I can't wait! I can't wait!
I can't wait! I can't wait!
And then he was gone. Reality was incomprehensible. The truth hopelessly come out of reach. And all we were left with was despair. We stood there, for I don't know how long, frozen in place. I couldn't think. It took everything I had to just keep myself standing upright. I don't understand any of this. What's despair entertainment and... how am I still alive?
I'm sick of this.
I thought that finally, we couldn't get out of here.
Yeah.
Plus, what did he say about the class trial?
Stop talking.
Well, that part's obvious. The class trial is the class trial. Which means is that at this point, we have to figure out who the culprit is. Figure out who killed Kyoko. What?
What the heck?
What are you talking about? I thought Mukuro Ikusaba was the one who died. The victim was female, right? Kyoko certainly fulfills that condition. And if Monokuma is still alive and active, then that means the mastermind, Mukuro Ikusaba, isn't dead. So naturally, the body belongs to her. So it must be Kyoko. There's no other possibility. But the hair color's different, though. I mean, the boots click. The... I don't know. The body is Kyoko's? Kyoko's been murdered? No!
So I'm assuming we're going back to the body, so you can, like, actually look at the hand then.
Well, the design's weird, but, we'll worry about that in a little bit. No, that's not possible! Because I don't know anything about her yet. I don't even know who she really is. To have it end like this. I don't believe it. I refuse to believe it. Whether you believe it or not, whether or not doesn't matter. The truth is the truth. If you refuse to believe it, it's your responsibility to uncover the truth for yourself. Myself? Anyway, we better begin.
But...
What? Oh, God, I can't. If we're gonna have a cross trial, then that means the killer.
That's right.
Correct. It must be someone participating in our school life. Wait. So you're saying one of us killed Kyoko? Well, that's not precisely what I'm saying, no.
Huh?
Huh? But you just said...
Stop talking.
I don't have time to explain now. There's a veritable mountain of issues I need to confirm. I'm going to begin my search. If you value your lives, you'll put everything you have into this. That's how this game works, after all. And so we lead into investigation mode. Well, I better start by checking out the Monokuma file. Due to the explosion, the victim's identity is unknown. They were, however, dead before the blast. The victim had been stabbed a single time with a knife, which went completely through the body. They also had been struck in the head with an object, about as thick as a metal pipe. The body was covered with, like, other wounds, but these were at least several days old. So even the Monokuma file doesn't tell us who the victim actually was. The unidentified body? Could it really be Kyoko? Or... I have no choice. I have to investigate. I have to uncover the truth for myself. No matter what, I have to find out what happened, or we're all dead. I need to go back to the scene of the crime, back to the garden.
Nice!
Monokuma file number 5 has been added to the truth bold section of your handbook. Okay, time to get started. I need to check anywhere that may be important from one end to another, to the other. I just need to do what I always do. Right. And that is actually an amazing place to stop, actually. Leave it on a cliffhanger so that people get intrigued and want to see more.
That's what Monokuma would say. To leave for the thrills, the chills, the kills!
Yeah, I'm gonna be sleeping.
Wait, what?
I said, yeah, I'm gonna be sleeping.
Yeah. But, so... This new intense chapter of DanganRonpa shows a new body found, but cause of an explosion. Where's Kyoko right now? Or is Kyoko the one murdered? We don't know these facts, but we'll figure them out later on. So, for those that at least remained in the stream, thank you guys very much for at least watching in the stream. You guys are awesome. Get a pat on the back. Pat, pat. But for those that are watching in the recorded version, thank you guys very much for at least watching this. In the next session of DanganRonpa, hopefully we can get it streaming back on YouTube instead of me having to constantly jump to Twitch for this constant repetition of it saying,
"Oh, yeah, you overqueued your game, so fuck you."
And I'm like, "Fuck you." And it's like, "Fuck you." And I'm like, "Fuck you, I'm going to Twitch." Wait, what? So, anyways, thank you guys very much for at least watching. And this has been Shin Nagawa.
Hey, my baby. My blankie doo. She goes, ah! She's like a Five Nights at Freddy's character. She goes, ah!
So for now. God damn it. So for now, to be continued. Till then, see you next time.
Bye!
Bye!
Yeah.